Bushido.
Fight.
Diego, looking to get in, looking to put a lot of pressure on him, and looking to make Tuft sweat. Tuft's just got to be on point with his anti-airs, stop all the pressure from Rash and Tubaware, and he'll be fine. But you know what? Let's get into it. Let's let their actions speak for themselves. No butt check. I love butt check. Getting right into it. All right, starting off early. Long combo breaks the heavy. Good stuff. Oh, caught low. No conversion though. Oh, caught low again, but converts this time. Drops the combo though. I'm setting stuff. Good reset, American reset.
I see a little bit of difference here that every time that Tubbo did the talk, he did not connect to the jump counter.
Ooh, a little bit early on the shadow counter, very upsetting. Ooh, good block on the TP from Tubaware. Alright, gonna put him in the corner wall splash. Throw him. Oh, teabagging! Ooh, I thought it was bad! We do it all day here. Ooh, a little bit late on that counter breaker. I like the idea though. He did try to break it. Just didn't work out. Ooh, a little bit earlier. Battle counter. God darn. That's gonna end the health bar.
Tubaware is way more valuable than you think. Can't just be tossing out that shadow counter. Get the teabags.
Very true. Ooh, good cross up. Use that mini kick. Get it overhead. City. Watch your dome.
Gonna break the medium. Next hit. Gonna try to get the health back.
Might have been a missed fireball motion there.
Alright,
looking to stay at neutral. Rash is gonna look to shoot those fireballs, get meters. Oh, but he's gonna get in. Full combo. Ooh, drop though. Where?
He can be DPing though, Duff.
Yeah. Duff is very early on his counter breakers, I've been noticing. Or his shadow counters.
Ooh!
But you know who's on point with their counter breakers? Tubaware is getting a sick counter breaker that's gonna lead to sick damage. In the corner! Almost. Good check with the check him out of the overhead. All right.
He's gonna toss him out the window. Oh, you know it.
Oh, leave the roof.
Out of my house.
Tubaware playing on the floor. I respect that.
Can't even see him because he just loves Frosty Fossings that much.
All I know is that he's Deadpool, and like, all I know is that Deadpool plays KI. That's pretty cool. We've unlocked the profile taunt for Rash. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, he's up 5 overheads this game.
5 overheads.
5 manuals.
So Tuff's just gotta be watching his pressure and just gotta tighten up his shadow counter timing because he has the right idea a lot of times, but he's just doing it too early or too late.
That get a little bit better on his anti-air game.
Very true.
Just get free inside just by jumping in with Wicked Tongue.
Very true. Alright, they're playing a little bit of neutral, but got out of it almost immediately.
Ooh, just a shadow counter.
Oh, free shadow counter again! Too early! Very striking.
Here's an opener.
Yeah, alright, calls in instinct. Here comes the car. Alright, block. Oh, but no conversion on that. Jump in. Ooh!
He got that one.
Got the counter breaker. Smart stuff from Tuff.
There we go. Okay.
Meter ender.
Look at the difference here. Almost full life bar for Tuff.
And brand new health bar. We do it. Crazy stuff. Oh, but great to see on Wake Up from Tuff. Good block on that overhead, though. All right, check him with the medium kick.
Ooh, again with shadow counters.
A little bit too early.
You gotta have a better idea than that. You're missing every time.
Ooh, caught him low. Smart stuff.
Okay.
I'm going for those. Oh, good break. All right, gonna lick it again. All right, use the opener. Smart stuff. Alright, wall slot? No, gonna use the boot ender.
DP, please,
yeah,
thank you.
Smart stuff. Use the instinct to freeze the screen so they can see it. Alright. That's not gonna work. If that was only a one-hitting move, like one-hit move, that would have worked for that. That's a multi-hitting move.
I was gonna say it's smart for him to try to use instinct at that life point. Don't waste the whole life bar or, you know, let yourself chase the life bar without using instinct.
Oh, this is gonna be some big damage. Oh, I don't know if you wanted that. Again, too late. Or too early on that. Not too late. Too late. He already hit. Overhead, smart stuff. Oh, but he misses the conversion again.
Flip out. Oh,
okay,
overhead.
Good stuff.
Love the flip out.
Oh, but he dropped the combo. Oh, he's got to end it. Ultra. Okay. There it is. All right, TV tough. 1-1.
All right, I feel like Tubaware got a little bit cocky in that round. You know, he's like, okay, this Jago doesn't know what he's doing.
This Jago.
And then
know what he's doing.
I mean, Jago wins, right, all the time.
Yeah,
you just gotta play him and you
best
win.
Best character. Top five.
Oh, no anti-air.
Again, like you said, he's just got to tighten up his anti-air, and he's definitely going to tighten up these conversions. Because if PB Chop has been able to, was able to convert off every one of the openings that he's had, he'd be up 2-0 right now.
Absolutely.
But Tubular is making much better work of the openings he's given. Like that. Boom. With the ZP, overhead city recap.
You just look at the different knowledge of both players. Yep. Tubular is definitely a very fundamentally sound player.
Very true.
And then we got Tuff playing Killer Instinct. No anti-air again.
But he breaks the medium. So that's
oh, but he's going to get anti-air.
Perfect round.
Yeah. There's really no reason for him to jump in there. He should have just stayed on the ground and maybe threw out like a crouch medium or tried to walk up. Didn't really work. Smart stuff.
Ooh,
a little bit early there. Or a little bit late. Alright, Shane Dender. Let's ball get it back in the corner.
He wants to keep him there because he noticed that Tuff has a hard time in that corner specifically.
I think Tubular has also noticed that Tuff really enjoys hitting buttons after block throws, and he's been punishing it with that shadow boot every time. Very smart stuff. Overhead, gonna clear that boot.
Thank you.
Oh, but that boot's just got a huge hitbox.
Don't just do it.
Yeah.
Sorry. Ooh, smart. That was smart. You're actually plus on that Shadow Link kick, so that's smart. Here's the teabag.
Ooh.
Eat the teabag.
But I don't know if you noticed this again. PB Tuff got a little impatient, thought it was his turn, and threw out another crouching button, had long startup, and got big booted for his trouble.
Absolutely.
Tubeware taking great advantage, reading his opponent, playing very solid right now.
Just because the instinct gives you plus two doesn't mean you get the best buttons for free.
Very true. Ooh, gets in right there. From the tongue. Thought he was going to throw out, but it didn't work out. Yeah. Alright.
This is telling the whole story. Anti-air.
Very true.
Here at time would be very disappointed.
Gosh darn. Hero Time does love his anti-air.
He does. As much as Tubular loves New York Tims. In the corner. Ooh, he finally gets a shadow counter.
Perfect. Strengthen up. This could be the adjustment that Tuff needs to bring this game back.
Good blocks.
But he needs the strength to tighten up these conversions.
Absolutely. One button is okay, but you got to keep going.
This is still hurting you. That one button goes into 20.
Yeah.
Alright. Next up.
Ooh, overhead. Next up, Tuff's medium.
Alright. Play a little bit of neutral, gonna toss up this big fireball.
He could've ate it!
He could've ate it and gotten all that meter. Crazy stuff.
No, punching heavy punch you with anything!
You know, like I've been saying, and people are gonna say, he's not going to say one thing. He's gotta strengthen up his conversion. Tubular has been doing it so much.
Oh. Okay, early lockout.
He's gonna be able to take advantage of this.
Don't pop.
No!
You
could have just done DP under
him.
Yeah, it would have killed. Oh, wrong super break. Now he's in the corner.
He's waiting for it. You see the difference in players.
Dark. Alright.
There we go.
Ooh,
get caught.
Thought he was gonna lick a tongue. What a recapture! I didn't even notice that thing. Okay.
Gave him a choice. Either take the tongue or take the car.
Try to hit him with the combo trade there. Yeah, it didn't really work out. But
the teabag's like, yeah. Ooh, Shadow King. That was kind
of smart stuff to be able to end the health bar there.
Yeah.
Alright, he's gonna go back to playing a little bit of neutral. He's gonna get some
fortune to Tuff. Won't get another instinct bar back.
Yeah. And Tuff's the one who really needs to get out of this area.
Yeah. That'll be,
yep.
Full ultra probably in the teabag.
Probably.
Or recapture the second ultra. Who knows?
Now Tubular is getting up.
He's getting up.
He might teabag. Yeah. He might push Tuff down.
We might
see something. We might see something I wasn't ready to see today.
Oh no!
No!
He did it. He's banned. This man is banned.
Tubular has done the E Honda stomp.
Oh,
he's done the E-Honda stomp, and he's done the teabag. Crazy stuff. Tubular, the man of many faces.
The man of many faces, many personalities, but always, always entertaining to watch in any game he plays.
But you know what? You know what else is entertaining to watch?
What's that?
You know, my favorite movie is Godzilla, And you know who's coming up next to play some Killer Instinct?
Don't tell me.
Godzilla's Wrath versus a character from one of my favorite games,
yo,
Pokemon! Level 45 Arcanine.
That's my They're Arcanine coming up right there. That's
right now.
That'd be the pick
stuff
I would choose. If I could choose a starter, it would definitely be Growlithe.
Growlithe?
I'm a fire type.
You know what? I'm going to be
fiery personality.
I'm going to be that, you know, what's that little ball character?
Which one? Voltorb?
No,
Electrode?
No, the new one.
Jigglypuff?
The new starter.
Oh, the new starter.
The new grass type.
Oh, the new grass type.
Yeah, it looks like an owl. He's really cute.
Oh, Rufflet. I love him.
He's my favorite.
He was my pick.
There's a plush maker that makes a lot of Smash plushes that had
a Rowlet.
Rowlet. You're right. A Rowlet plush that and like had an adjustable head that would go 180 degrees. And she was giving it away on Twitter, and it was the greatest looking thing ever.
Oh, it is adorable.
Oh man, I'm like 10 seconds away. Like I'm gonna get my last few paychecks from this current job that I'm working, and then I'm gonna have her commission Fatty from Killer Instinct, one of Gargos' minions. Either I think it's Dretch.
Dretch.
Yes, I'm gonna get Dretch made into a plushie, and I'm gonna love him. And then people are gonna come over to my apartment, and they're gonna see him on my couch, and they're gonna be like, What's that? And I'm gonna have a very awkward conversation with them.
Well, so I know level 45 Arcanine, tangent into this match here. A level 45 Arcanine, he does play Saberwolf, and it looks like it was a Saberwolf mirror.
Ooh, this is gonna be very. This is gonna be.
Yes, it is. Okay.
This is gonna be bitey. You know, like the Simpsons, the Itchy and Scratchy show.
Yeah,
they fight, they bite, they fight, they bite, they bite.
Yeah, I think they're gonna go tooth and nail, to be quite honest.
Oh boy. But they didn't even go to Sableye stage, which is very upsetting.
Wanted to make sure there wasn't any lag.
Very true. Level 45 Arcanine. I don't know if you caught this. Taunt at the very start of the match.
He's ready.
All right, Godzilla Wrath. Opening up level 45 Arcanine.
We got jabs.
We got jumps. We got jabs and jumps. We got sweeps.
Jump in. Toss.
Good stuff.
That's the classic. Saberwolf bread and butter. Ooh!
That's going to work. That's a slow move. That shadow counter is fast enough. It's going to work. Throws him again. Ooh, woke up with a jab. Good smart stuff from Arcanine to back that shot.
Arcanine is a smart player. Last year, he actually broke into top 8 last year.
That is true.
So, can he make the repeat appearance?
You know what? I'm just going to say this, if a level 45 Arcanine can make top 8 again this year, I think I'm going to have to be singing some Pokemon theme on commentary.
I brought the Ash Ketchum hat.
Oh boy!
We got this. Okay, but all right, turning it right around, Godzilla's Wrath. Full sticky bar.
Almost having full bar, full health right now.
Yeah.
In this third round, essentially.
Good air there.
I have a 45 Arcanine can play back. He doesn't really need to go in because he has the life lead.
Exactly.
Ooh!
Throwing it out there.
Good counter from Godzilla's Wrath, but good combo breaker from level 45 Arcanine. Another good air there.
Okay.
Throw. Ooh! He's going to get punished for his trouble.
Yeah.
Yes, he is. He might have been able to Feral Council out of that. Not sure, though. Be a lot of this matchup. They're going to try to get to this mid-range space,
right,
and they're going to try to catch each other with the same button. So that's what we're seeing right now.
Who's the better button presser?
But you know what? I'm not seeing any shadow counters from Godzilla's Wrath or level 45 Arcanine on these double claws or whatever.
Yeah.
Or I can't remember. Dragon Edge.
Dragon Edge.
I think that's back heavy. It's Dragon Edge.
No, it's Overpower.
Overpower, that's right.
Okay, and then Danger Zone, and
that's
going to
be it. Arcanine's
got it. Arcanine leveled up, yeah!
Yeah, level 46 Arcanine. It's going to be a level 50 Arcanine if he wins all three of these.
Yes.
Which I believe he turns into.
Let's turn it, I think that's it.
He turns into Sableye.
Oh!
Oh!
Uh-oh.
No. We should have done a button check. You did say that they were going in without a button check. And now they're not.
Hey, You're screwed. So
yeah,
make sure you do the
button checks. But are they just gonna get back into it? Or are they gonna? No, they're not even gonna attempt it. They're just gonna get right back into it. All right, level 45 Arcanine is playing really in his opponent's face right now. All right, good break in that medium. Again, no shadow counter.
Right, just let it happen.
All right, ooh, good break in the light. air to air.
No counter, no counter breaker attempts from either player either.
Very true.
Here comes, ooh,
good punish. Oh. Yes. That move is not quite quick enough to hit. Alright. Flip out. Ooh, a little bit early. Yeah. Timing might be different. He might be playing on a TV at home. And when he comes back and he's playing on all these monitors with no input delay, he might just get the timing wrong.
Or so tournament nerves.
Tournament nerves, very true.
Okay. Gets caught low.
But break again. Clears are breaking everything. If I'm one of them, I have to make a read.
Ooh, no, he didn't have to do that. He's so punishable off of that. Unless he barrel canceled, but he's about out.
Very true. Good punish. Knew he was going to throw Godzilla's Wrath and use the Eclipse.
And that's the other scary thing about Wolf's Instinct. He does damage, chip damage on his normals while he's in Instinct. So you got to be careful with that.
Godzilla's Wrath could have taken a little bit better advantage of that lockout situation, but still was able to put up decent damage. Alright, once again in this neutral space. There it is, throw. Working on what you're gonna do, back up. He has the life lead, it's gonna be going!
Didn't need to.
Didn't need to, but did. He got hit. Got punished for his trouble. Alright, Arcanine rushing in. Or no, sorry, Godzilla's Wrath rushing in. Ooh, a little bit too far for that throw.
Again,
not sure what he was
so
looking
far
for.
Away from that. Probably looking for another sweep attempt.
Yeah, but there's not really a string that goes into it from that.
Exactly.
So Godzilla's Wrath being able to put up big damage right now, and that's going to be it. Good job with combo to end it. 1-1. 1-1, level 45, Arcanine. Godzilla's Wrath.
This is looking like a real even mirror matchup, if
yeah.
I do say so myself.
Yeah. Both players very content to play in the very limited range if they want to.
Right.
And very content to stay. And like stay away from that, stay away from each other when they have a life lead. Very smart stuff that I like to see. So it breaks the light and have a smart stuff.
So the way you do this, you play a really solid neutral with this character.
Very true.
One of those characters that if you want to learn how to do well with Saber Wolf, do a mirror and learn to do well, just like Jago does.
Right, because the characters are so like fundamentally sound that like it's easier to learn. Oh! But there it is, he released
clapped.
He released that button just a bit earlier and punished him for it. Smart stuff. Godzilla's Wrath making some very key, some major key adjustments
and alerts.
Major key alerts. Shadow counter on point. Both characters. Oh wow, both players are just looking at each other in the face. Arcanine was like, ooh, whoa! No punish,
no
from
shadow
of Wrath.
Nothing.
Very crazy exchange right there.
Were they both panicked about the scenario?
I would assume so.
A little four-ender, good.
All right. Toss out a button. I think he was trying to bait out an eclipse, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
All right, just gonna end it. Flip out? No. Try to go for another eclipse in there. Good punish. Godzilla's Wrath. Oh, big damage incoming. Lockout. Ooh, but break! Got a little bit too greedy, gotta finish your plate. But that new PD change that was introduced, I believe, this patch? It's gonna make it so there's just a very little bit of white life, or I believe 50% of white life that you've accumulated in the previous combo remains now after Combo Breaker, which helps with the people, which effectively hurts Combo Breaker. And because people were thinking that Combo Breakers were too strong, and so we said, all right, we'll do this change to the mechanics, and we'll do this system change. And we asked you guys in the community, and you guys said, this is a very good idea.
I like the idea.
We like the idea. Put it in our game, my fine good sir.
And you did.
And you did.
Going to character select here. Okay, is he thinking or is he switching? Arcanine did lose the last round.
That is true. So and
Godzilla has momentum.
That is true. And Godzilla also does have to stay with Sable Wolf because he did win last round. But they're looking like they're having a jolly good time up there. I saw level 45 Arcanine yucking it up there.
He's always having a good time, right?
Always having a good
time. This guy's personality.
He's always catching Pokemon.
Always.
Always catching Pokemon.
Glacius.
You know what? This is the counter pick.
It is.
This is the counter pick to the matchup.
Is he really? It's too late. You can't stop him.
Yes, you can. He can go back.
Who's gonna?
Is Tubeware gonna get on stage if like he hits the B button and he's gonna push him out of his chair and start
just teabagging away?
Yeah, I don't think that's right.
It definitely isn't right. I would not be okay if that happened.
Yes.
Okay, let's see here. I've never seen Arcanine play Glacius.
Very true. But getting back to the earlier point, I also wouldn't stop it. because I just kind of want to see what Tibor would do.
Oh,
I just love it. I also don't think I could beat. I don't think I could stop it because I think Tibor would just like push me out of the way because I'm like a twat. I'm a child. Oh, but all right. Godzilla's Wrath playing the matchup very right now, punishing everything Arcanine's tossing out. Oh, but it's gonna get hit. Oh, we're gonna break. Almost immediate break. All right. What's in the corner? Oh, stagger.
I don't think this is anywhere Arcanine wants to be. Oh, try to
puddle punch. Try to hold it, but this doesn't work out. Godzilla's Wrath showing he knows this matchup. He's not going to be able to shadow counter this. Doesn't have a meter. But he's going to get thrown for his trouble. Chicago punish.
Okay.
Mediums, good break. Glacius does have instinct, so he does have one hit of armor, but one hit's going to chip him out anyway. There it is. He's still alive in the air, and then as soon as his feet touch the floor, just died.
My legs.
Just so majestic.
They're nothing but ice, and they're melting in this rain.
I'm melting.
Oh, okay, that's smart with the hail. Keep himself safe.
Ooh, good punish. Using that new leaping slash tool he was given in Season 3 Save the World.
Here we go.
All right, long damage. Lockout.
Finally,
oh,
let's go.
But he could have converted that into so much more damage. Glacius can convert very large damage.
Absolutely. All he needs is one bar.
Very true. Oh, good tech. Ooh, good punish.
Tried to bait that. Oh, nice.
Good break from Godzilla's Wrath. Run up. Oh, caught him low. Oh, try to go for the heavy counterbreaker didn't work. He gets punished for his trouble. Level 45 Arcanine. Can he bring it back? It's a huge life deficit. It's going to be very hard. All right, going to activate Instinct. Get portal punch.
Nice.
Good stuff. Lockout. This is big damage. He's got meter. Ooh. He's done it a little bit earlier into shoulder, and the damage in her would have been perfect.
Yep.
All right. Gotta start tossing out hail. Multi-hail.
Oh, no, okay.
The hail hits, but he's not able to convert. Oh, and that's going to be it. Caught him.
Oh, no.
Godzilla's Wrath has destroyed level 45 Arcanine.
No, he fainted.
He fainted. That's right. Level 45 Arcanine fainted. I don't know why. I just thought that I was calling him level 47 Arcanine.
Because he leveled up.
Oh, you're right. That's right.
That's why.
But
wow, you know what I would have liked to seen is optimizing those combos with Glacius.
Glacius
was a smart pick, but I think at the end of the day, Godzilla just ended up he got in his stride. You saw in the beginning of the match, he started out kind of, you know, like, okay, I kind of know what I'm doing, and then it's like, all right, this is real. I need to get it together, and then just you saw a completely different play from him. Started using feral cancels more, took advantage of his abilities.
All right.
But next up, we're looking at just go with A versus King Cash.
And you know what's crazy about Cash, just that word, is that in March, I think there's this thing called the Killer Instinct World Cup.
The Killer Instinct World Cup,
where
is that?
There's a $30,000 pop bonus provided by the Killer Instinct Ultra Tour.
What?
And I think this is a Killer Instinct World Cup qualifier.
It's the Ultra Tour.
It's the Ultra Tour that's providing the...
It's a part of the Ultra Tour.
Right.
So, here.
Oh, $30,000 in cash and pop bonuses. First place, top 32 payout. Sorry, I'm sporadically saying
this. It's
top
amazing.
32 payout for Killer Instinct out of a $30,000 prize pool that is ever expanding because of the community fund. Yes. That Kilgore is coming. Is here,
what?
My bad, not coming. He's already here. He's got machine guns for hands. He is insane. He's available today for $9.99. Half of that, I believe $5, is going to the Killer Instinct Community Fund, mm-hmm. to the 2017 event on the Killer Instinct Ultra Tour. So the prize pot for the World Cup's ever expanding. The prize pot for future Killer Instinct tournaments is ever expanding. And Killer Instinct as a community and as a game is ever expanding.
So, as an example, today's pop bonus was what, $1,000?
$1,000, something like that.
So, how many Kilgores is that? You can get
how many? I think that's 100 Kilgores. That's 100 Kilgore
units.
So
you're telling me 100 Kilgores at this tournament, but Killer Instinct World Cup, you could potentially get how many Kilgores?
I think you could potentially get 3,000 Kilgore units. Now, I know what you're thinking. Can I become Arya if I have that many Kilgore units?
What do you think?
I don't know. Ask Rico Suave because he won last year. Rico Suave, I know, has a couple Kilgore units. But you know who we're not going to see Kilgore units? We're not going to see Kilgore units. We're going to see Sybil versus Conrad.
Well, that's a shame. But I guess we'll
But you
see.
Know what? We're going to see the guy who's got the Campbell's chicken noodle possibilities, Conrad.
The possibilities!
The possibilities of that Campbell's chicken noodle soup versus Sybil. Now, I don't know if Sybil really likes soup, but I think he's going to try to get some of that soup. Oh, but this is...
But we are doing button checks right here. Oh,
they're going to reposition the HUD.
We don't like the HUD. We don't
they're
like
going to change the brightness.
The toast. Probably the toast.
You're going to want to display the HUD.
I hope you display
I really
the
hope
HUD.
They display the HUD because we're what not going to be able to see health. No! You want
toast.
Yeah.
He wants toast off.
They want to turn toast off.
That's what it is.
Don't get rid of the HUD.
Let's get rid of...
That's just the player tags. I don't think there's a way to remove those. Yeah, because I think those are linked to the actual like individual
yeah,
like
it,
Xbox
it's
profile.
It's linked to the Xbox.
The only way to turn those off is to effectively turn off the HUD, and then you're turning off your shadow bar, your instinct bar, your health bar, which is upsetting. But you know what?
If you're a good player, you know what's going on.
You just gotta roll with it.
You just gotta go.
You know?
All right, so after this fight, we're going to be seeing Hollywood Sleep, F3.
Flip side tactics. You know,
Hollywood Sleep.
Life got twists turned upside down.
And then he's going to be fighting the DJ Jello Cups.
Yo, DJ Jello Cups. Now, I don't know who he plays, and I wish there was like a gelatinous character in Killer Instinct that he could have played. Because, oh, he could play Glacius.
He could play Glacius. He could play Cinder, a green Cinder.
That's true. That is, he'd be Jello. Oh my, I'm going to flip my biscuits. If
good
he plays,
golly gosh.
Good golly gumdrops if he plays Cinder and or Glacius.
We are in for a treat.
But speaking of Cinder, King Cash.
Is that Kool-Aid Cinder?
Kool-Aid Cinder.
It's blueberry Kool-Aid.
That's more like pre-workout Cinder.
Oh, yep. The electric fire.
That Cellucor for C4 blueberry, blue ice Raz.
And we got Benny.
Maximilian.
You know, he's a little adorable puppy that just grew into a monstrosity and he's going to tear things apart.
Benny. All right. Is this
real? This is not real.
All right.
Okay, this is not
game
really
one
yet.
Over.
We're gonna yep. Let's see.
I think
all
right. So they're doing best of three. They're doing best of three.
It is a World Cup
first hit only.
So
first hit only, best of three. Gosh darn.
And this is exciting. I'm really interested to see who they're gonna play.
Yeah, this is the entire gimmick right now.
Because
I know neither of these players.
No, I don't.
And they've picked essentially two different characters each time, which has been very weird. But it looks like they finally got their characters. Kid Cash can be playing Cinder. Just go with A, playing that Sabrewolf, that Banny.
Banny.
And then he's playing the Cinder with the shoulder pad on. Look at the like burn.
He's got like an igniter right there.
He's got a bad shoulder. He dislocated it. It's in a sling.
It's inflamed, you could say.
Oh. Oh gosh darn. Gosh darn. All right, let's see what kind of Cinder King Cash is. He's a rushdown Cinder, a zoning Cinder. All right, there we go. My kind of Cinder, playing a little bit of that zoning technique.
Little fireballs. Oh, caught him on the air.
Oh, and that's going to early alert. I don't agree with that. Just didn't finish his combo. He could have done so much more damage.
Uh-huh.
All right, good throw. Just go with that.
DP, nothing. Okay.
Recapture. Oh, but good break in the medium. Benny, just headbang. Just go with that. Oh, good throw.
Good toss.
Ooh, punishment. No conversion.
What's he going to do with the bomb? I bet magic was going to happen, but it's not anymore because counter broken and very little damage. Wow. Not taking advantage of that.
No, these players need to work on their conversion. I've said this once before, two games ago. Let's say it again. They need to work on their conversion.
Just go with A. He's only pushing his heavy for stagger. And you know, I don't know.
I don't agree with that.
Maybe he's not... He could be new to the
game. He could be new. But, you know, both these players, you know, they're just content to play a little bit away from each other at very similar health bars. Not one needs to go in more than the other. There's 66 seconds left on the clock. The King Cash gonna be able to convert, but drops his combo.
Just go with A,
going for another early shadow counter attempt.
You know what it could be? Just go with A is trying too much.
It's true.
You know, he does have the stagger. Maybe he thinks he's getting another stagger hit in. You know, just, you're Saberwolf.
Very true.
Keep it simple.
He's also canceling that run into moves that would whiff at very far ranges, which is very weird. And if King Cash can realize that, he's going to be able to turn this game around for him to get the lead back.
I don't know why Just is only using heavy.
Yeah.
Saberwolf has amazing buttons, but he's only using heavies.
Very true. But right now he's content to play the zoning game and let Just go with a essentially kill himself because he's just hitting, he's hitting buttons and he's being in the air enough. And you can't block in the air in this game like you can in a game, say, like Marvel or like an Air Dasher.
Or any anime fighter.
That's why I said Air Dasher.
Oh, opener under
situation, no break. All right, throw.
You know, he didn't break it because he has full instinct.
That's
not
true.
Neither play. He's using early lockout.
Very true. Speaking of Devil, just go with A, activates instinct.
That's the commentator's coaching right there.
Commentator's coach.
Okay. But he's still making it. He's still okay. He's still fine. It's all right. He's still won.
All right. Just go with A. I think he needs to calm down. It looks like he's having a little bit too much fun up there.
This is the
players are talking. They're like, yo, everything's wrong.
I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what you're doing. But it's a roller coaster
I wouldn't say
ride
that because they're showing they understand it. It's just that they're not effectively using the tools.
That's fair.
Correctly.
That is absolutely fair.
They haven't reached that level where they're doing the most optimized thing.
Yeah, the most
every
optimal
time.
Situation every time.
They're not on like the same level as maybe asleep, but give it time and I'd be sure that with the right coaching and the right learning, both of these players could be possible contenders.
Everybody's
for
a killer out in killer
for the
instinct.
Killer instinct.
I mean,
World
Cup. Last chance qualifier. There's gonna be four last chance qualifiers
like there were last year. They're one bracket pool of death style, so that's gonna be fun. But Just Cash gonna stick with Cinder. Just go with A. Gonna stick with the Saberwolf, and we're gonna right back into it.
Maybe we'll use less heavies
and more.
More of that good
lights.
Neutral game that Saberwolf has.
Yes, very true. The neutral game that we saw a lot of in the mirror match that we saw last match.
Was amazing.
Very good neutral.
The taunt. Here we go. He's ready. He smells blood.
He started it.
He said his buttons were wrong. That's what it was.
That's what it was. That's the gimmick.
Okay. Okay, he doesn't care. Anti-air.
Good at clips.
Look at this. Never say roll.
Oh, early lockout. This is going to be big damage.
Oh, it's going to be meter.
It's going to be some good stuff. All right.
A little bit.
Not. Just a little bit too far for that.
Xbox Cinder, what are you doing?
Xbox Cinder. Xbox. Stop.
Activate.
Xbox, turn off. All right. Ooh, drops it. Like I said, they got to tighten up these conversions. They're dropping a lot of, like,
opener-ender.
They're also not breaking opener-ender. This is the second opener-ender situation we've seen. And there's been one from both players. Alright, is King Cash gonna break? He is! Just go but not a max damage combo from Just Go With A.
You know, you have all that time to do what you want, especially with Saberwolf's combo trait.
Very true.
Another returns the counter. Okay, it drops
it. Drops it.
This is a roller coaster of a fight. It really is, because I'm like, okay.
Oh boy. Just go with A. Has lively.
Okay,
punishes. Smart stuff. All right, is he going to be able to recapture? Is he going to go for it? No, opposite, just
clap.
Yeah, just clap.
It's not Armika.
It's not.
Can't be doing that.
All right, King Cash. Going to just pretend to kind of back up, play a little bit safe. Oh, but he's going to... Ooh, the breakdown light. Oh, good throw from Just Go With A. Throws him out of the corner, though. Don't agree with that. Throws him back in. Smart stuff. All right.
Okay, good roundhouse. And suits.
King Cash.
Tried the OTG.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, didn't work. Just go that has the life lead, but is now in the corner. But he's that's good. Again. I don't know if something's wrong, but he's getting. This game would be over two times by now if he had been able to convert off either one of those counter breakers.
It's hey.
You know, it's a hard knock play.
When you're at a tournament,
when you're at
a live setting,
when you are at a Killer Instinct World Cup qualifier.
Beg my pardon, I'm sorry. I apologize.
You get nervous.
I'm really underselling this. entire...
You get nervous.
Yeah, you know will
who,
get nervous.
You know whose hands
the
I were watching?
The last live qualifier.
I was watching Calypso's hands today while he was playing Nikki.
Yeah.
They were shaking.
Oh, yeah.
You wouldn't expect... You wouldn't expect a player like Calypso, one of the best Sidiras, to be, for their hands to be shaking. But this is a Killer Instinct World Cup qualifier.
The last live qualifier.
The last
in America.
In the United States. The Continental. Well.
Yes.
Like,
except for online.
Except for online, of course.
So last offline.
Yes, but there will be more coming very soon.
Woo, for 2017.
All right.
Here we go. He's got a shadow bomb on him.
Ooh,
really cool.
That looked very weird because he was upper body in ball on that because he's love very faint.
Ooh.
Good stuff with the leaping slash to get in, but it gets broken. Oh, good break on the heavies.
Ooh, trying to go for the throw, but too far.
All right, throws two bombs. Bomb hits. All right, King Cash able to open up a break again on the recapture.
Ooh, slides.
King Cash needs to realize that he's breaking that every time and start shadow counter that.
He tried.
Speaking
he tried.
Of shadow countering that, just go with A. Shadow counter of his own didn't work, or counter breaker of his own didn't work out. Again, he needs to work on these counter breakers. He's broken it every time. Even just attempting it and just go with A, him not breaking, it at least sends a message that, like, I'm willing to do this. Sure, I'm going to die, but I'm willing to at least do this move, and it's going to put the fear.
Right. Ooh, wasting the shadow, but he tosses it, so wrong choice to punish.
Open-render again. All right, there it is. This time a kill, so he can't break it.
He's going to get that. Oh, no, he's just going to do damage. Could have got meter.
Could have gotten meter. Sad stuff. Oh, taunt. Oh, toss him in the corner. This is where Just Go Where They wants him. King Cash has to get out of his corner.
Again, that's
no shadow
counter. Not going to work.
And no shadow counter from King Cash. He had the bar. He just chose to spend it. Oh, good throw. Smart stuff. Throw him out of the slide. Jumps in. Sweeps him. Oh, good throw. Just go with A. Wrenches in. Oh, slides under it. Okay.
That was smarter. That was lucky. I don't know. Either way, it looked great.
Just go with A. Rushes in. He's going to catch him.
He's going to get to 2-0.
All right. King Cash didn't bite there, but he's going to be able to brick again.
Oh, he's able to
open under again. Oh, just
okay,
trying to toss a bomb in his face. Didn't work out. Just go with A. Takes it 3-0
yeah,
over
that was
King 3-0. Cash.
Oh, man. Full ultra.
Full ultra.
No teabags.
Ultra combo. That was it.
That was it.
He's so happy. He's like, I did it.
I did good.
I did good.
You know, you won your match. It's great.
He did good.
You stuck to your game plan. But next up, people with game plans, Hollywood Sleep. Flipside Tactics, very own Hollywood Sleep, versus the Detroit Jello Cups. Oh, the pudding in the...
Oh, good golly. Gumdrops. So we know Sleep plays a variety of characters. He plays, of course, Arbiter.
Arbiter.
He plays Arbiter. He played Conron in Season 2.
Yes.
We really haven't seen it in Season 3. He's
Glacius.
Yeah. But he is also... I've seen him play Glacius in Season 2 and Season 3.
Okay, okay.
But...
Yeah, you're right.
But he's recently, I believe, since Yumacon. Yumacon was the first time he brought her out. That Maya...
The mayonnaise.
That mayonnaise. Sleep... playing.
Did you mention Gargos as well?
Oh, I did not. Of
yeah,
course, he
Gargos.
Won Evo with Gargos. He beat
yes.
Ultra Arcade, beat Ultra Arcade's Bass in Evo Grand Finals with Gargos.
Yeah.
And that was just after, I believe, the character had dropped, maybe about a month after or so.
Yeah. It was very early Gargos.
Very early. But, oh, rocking the Flipside Tactics. Sorry, I interrupted you. I just saw him, like, puff open his shirt, and I was like, oh, just flexed on him. He just, like, flexed. He's like, ooh.
Remember the green light.
Ooh.
Flip side.
Tactics F3.
Yo, did he get this dude his hat? No, he's not.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think
for me. I'm about to beat you.
I think he's wearing an Evo.
Okay,
hat.
All right, cool. Which is brought
which,
by Gaming
which,
Generations.
Which is brought to you by Gaming Generations, another sponsor of this wonderful event, Frosty Fossics. But
look
I also
that.
Want to talk about the Evo,
ooh, the Evo
voting. And if you like KI and you want to see it for a fourth year at Evo, go on to generosity.com and donate to the Killer Instinct Evo poll. It's donate what you can, and if you can't donate, spread the word, post it on social media. Maybe one of your friends will be like, I like Killer Instinct
right.
too. and like donate $10 million.
Or, you know, somebody is generous because it goes to a good cause.
Right.
I'm trying to remember the cause. It was a, it was a children's hospital, wasn't it?
St. Jude, right? No, no.
Not it was St. Jude.
Make-A-Wish.
That's right. Make-A-Wish.
Twitch does all the St. Jude stuff.
That's right. That's right.
That's where I got my Twitch hoodie from.
Ooh. Twitch everywhere.
Twitch hoodies are very nice. If you ever have a chance to buy a Twitch hoodie, I highly recommend it. It's just very expensive.
Okay.
Because there are so few. It's a very nice. It's a purple hoodie. And it supports...
Why is it purple?
Because Twitch is purple.
No, it's indigo.
I had an art teacher. I had an art teacher who legitimately told a group of like kids in like fourth grade
that they are triggered by this.
That they are no longer. It is no longer called purple, but it's called indigo.
You guys could have seen his face.
I was so confused. So now I'm looking at Flipside Tactics Sleeps Arbiter, and I'm like, is that purple? Is that indigo? Is that plum? Like,
is it black and gold?
Is it black and gold? Is it blue and black? Like, I don't know. But all right, we got DJ Jellicubs rocking the Omen, another gelatinous character.
A gelatin character.
Ah! I respect it. DJ Jellicubs knows how to please the commentator.
He gets caught by the grenade.
Very true. Oh, I thought that blow would have hit. Alright, breaks the lights. Smart surf with Jellicup. Alright, slides in but gets punished for his troubles. Sleep, one of those players who has everything that he does optimized and only does the optimal thing in the situation. So, Jellicup. Oh!
Yep.
Wow.
Smart tech right there.
Speaking of optimization, look at that tech. Making the Shadow Hood only hit three times. Great. Alright, Omen tried to get out. Recap is going to hit. Is Omen going to be able to punish that?
Yes.
He is.
Locking out the Shadow as well.
He didn't have Shadow Bar, so it really wasn't that big of a
loss.
But now he has. Ooh, rushes in.
Oh, my goodness.
Not going to work. All right, one chance. Oh, puts himself in the corner. Not a good place to be against Arbiter. This is where the Vortex is going to start. Shoots him for good measure. Ends the life bar.
Got a double tap.
Bro, ooh, beats it out with a light kick, I believe. Heavy.
Ooh, he whipping him.
Whipping
him with that sword.
Oh, gonna pop. Yeah, he's gonna pop so he becomes a critical end ball. He's no longer.
Oh, good parry. Only he can only parry in sync. Arbiter.
Very true. Very true. Gameplay mechanic. Facts. Major key. Parry.
Oh, look at that. He said, no.
No. I don't like it. I'm gonna turn into a ball creature. Ooh, trying to throw, but he was still on hit stun.
Not.
Overhead. Ooh. Throws him out of it. Smart stuff. Oh. He has to block the grenade. Punish him. Good check on the the command grab. But good shot. Upsetting.
It's a shame.
Upsetting.
Another victory, yes, but there is always another
battle. DJ Jellicups looks a little bit concerned right now. He's looking at the screen. He's like, you know, I kind of, you know.
That could have gone differently.
It could have gone differently. I could have hit him with a couple more fireballs. I could have gotten hit less. But it didn't. I just got to play back.
If he had things in the right place, it's just, you know. But he found a way out of it. He wasn't able to adjust to those reactions.
But you know who's got things in the right place? Sleep. That counterbreaker was in the right place. Oh, it was in the right place again. Gosh darn. Flipside tactic. Sleep. Taking it.
Open book here.
Open
DJ
book.
Yellow cups.
All right.
All right.
Oh, he does it. Gush. Gush.
Good shenanigans.
Good shenanigans. Blazambo. All right. Lockout. Big damage. All right. Finishes his plate, something that we haven't been seeing a lot of players do recently. Ooh, but he uses the grenade to get off him and stop the pressure.
Ooh,
He doesn't let him do it.
He thought that, he probably thought the shadow was going to continue.
Oh, true.
Didn't react.
All right, ooh, try to catch him on counterbreakers on medium, didn't work.
Uh-huh.
Omen going to slide in. Ooh, okay. Opposite side, smart stuff.
That's
all right, but he's going to get hit by the fireball. Sleep gets caught high. Activates the bar. Get the shield on him.
Here we go. Let's see the vortex. Oh, no vortex.
Oh, but he's projected out in bowl because of the bar and the shield. The overshield. Oh, he's going to activate instinct. Oh! Grenade manuals into a wall splat? Crazy.
Oh, good slip. Watch the toes.
Oh, but he's projected out in bowl during that ender, too.
Yep,
that's why he was able to recover so quickly. All right.
Locks out a bar.
Right. Double Cups is only behind by half a health bar. Omen can definitely do this. If he gets to the bar, he can do Demonic Despair.
He might not even need that.
He might not. He's playing really solid right now. Oh, sleep. Oh, but gets locked out on heavies.
It's going to hurt.
This might be it, because he is going to shoot him. Ooh, but he's going to get out by the chip, yeah.
Yep,
nothing really Jellicups could have done. He was in a very hard situation to get out of. He tried to get out of it, but he didn't advance anywhere with the Shadow Ball. So, very weird.
Yeah, it was, you know, a lot of interesting moments in this match, for sure.
Very true.
I mean, Jellicups is not doing really a lot of wrong, per se.
But Sleep's just doing a lot right.
Yes.
He's making the correct reads, and he's making the correct decisions at the right moments.
Oh, good. Kept himself safe with those fireballs.
All right, what's the mix-up? Okay. Oh, just jump back in, come back. Jump back and came back in.
Yeah, oh. Okay.
Bro. Oh, throws him out of the corner. I don't agree with that. Could have gotten the full combo.
Yep, exactly. Ooh. Should have teleported to make that sword slash miss.
All right. He's going to be projectile invul, and he's going to be able to parry now that he's an instinct. That overshield is going to recharge. He's not going to be affected by the grenade. There's the overshield. Stab. Is he going to shoot him? No, I'll just put the grenade on 50-50. Ooh, overshield's going to protect him. Jump back grenade combo. Looking back to the early days of Season 3.
Right.
Overshield again is going to protect him. Smart stuff. And that's going to be the end of the health bar. Sleep playing super smart right now. Optimizing his tech. Playing really smart. Jellicups just needs to adapt.
Both bars locked out for Sleep.
Very true.
Not that he really needs them.
But this is going to help him in a key way, or help Jellicups in a key way, because he's not going to be able to activate Overshield, but now he is.
Man grab
him out of that. Smart stuff. Oh, but he's going to get recaptured.
Tried to react to the overhead. That was wrong timing, wrong choice, but he at least reacted.
All right, Omen has no bar. Opts to go for a one chance. He's going to get popped by the overshield. He's now projectile invul. Shotgun in, lockout. Since he did come in with the shotgun, it's going to scale pretty heavily. Oh, but he's overshield. He's not going to be affected by that. And that's going to... Oh, but he dropped
it.
That was going to be it, I was going to say.
And now, oh. Sleep.
Playing with your food right there. I don't like that.
This could cost him.
Could cost him the game. Oh, dying lock.
He said just mash that parry.
He just a moment 37.
He said, like, I don't care.
Did you know? I believe it was in one of the videos for Shadow Lords when they're showing off the new guardians and stuff. There's the parry pet, or the parry guardian.
Right.
And in the video, when we were making it, we were like, all right, how are we going to make this video? And we're like, let's do it like Daigo's moment 37, where in Third Strike, he parried Chun-Li's lightning legs. And so we used Omen's lightning legs. And so he just parried all of them, and it was really cool. And we're like, yeah.
But what a touching moment at IG, right?
What a tender Iron Galaxy moment.
Tender Iron Galaxy.
Well, that's what we call them when we were making Dive Kick, and when we would stream, they would call them tender moments.
Right.
And Dave Lang would say something very touching to Adam, and it was very heartfelt, and it was my favorite part of every stream.
Okay.
And you know, I missed that since Adam moved out to Orlando.
Sad. Poor Adam.
I wouldn't say poor Adam. He's at a place where it's 70 degrees instead of a place where it's, I think today it was 22 degrees.
Yeah.
I envy him.
Yeah, you're doing well, Adam.
He's doing well.
We miss you.
We miss him. We miss him, though.
All right, so up next we have Ultra Arcade's very own.
Bass?
I have to say bass. Canonically, I have to say base.
Well, it's kind of weird that you have to say base, because my last name is Gibson, and I have a guitar.
And then he's going up against Just Go With A.
Just Go With A what?
Of which you remember from the Saberwolf versus Cinder matchup.
Right. And you remember base from almost every top 8 of the last 2 years.
That's not true. He only showed up in Killer Instinct. Psych! Remember, he did place top 8 in Street Fighter Cross Tekken 1 year at EVO.
What?
Basted?
Basted. You don't remember. Want to know why you don't remember?
Why?
Because he was put down as B-A-S.
Oh. Like the Japanese bass? Or is there like a Japanese player?
No, not named Boss.
Nah. No, I'm thinking of the CBS2 player, the really good CBS2 player.
Oh, no, I don't remember.
Oh, no.
But, yeah.
Yeah.
Ultra Arcade, of course, is the guys that are helping out with the Ultra Tour.
Which they're helping out with the Ultra Tour, but the Ultra Tour is alongside Microsoft.
Right.
But they're the ones putting on the Killer Instinct World Cup with the $30,000 pop bonus in March. It is going to be lit. I know that I will possibly, most likely, be there. You can't keep me away.
Yeah, definitely.
If I heard, because I'm pretty sure there's going to be a saucy sweet.
Woo!
And if you know me, the boy wonder, T-Swizzle, cannot resist the saucy sweet. I will walk 1,000 miles to a saucy sweet.
And don't forget as well, it's going to be hosted at the Tobin Center of San Antonio, right on the Riverwalk in San Antonio. If you've never been there before, oh my goodness, that whole area is outstanding. I love the Riverwalk.
I've never been there. I used to live in Texas, but not near there, and I was 3 when I lived there, so
really, well, I don't remember
a lot from Texas, to be fair. Okay. But you know who doesn't remember a lot about their real past life?
Who?
Spinal.
Spinal?
Spinal. I don't know. I just made up my own.
He remembers. He still fights like a Viking thing.
I just made up my own Killer Instinct cannon. I hope you know that. But Spinal, Bass, looking to get everything started. Looking to put him in the corner like almost immediately. Yeah,
absolutely.
Just putting on. Because he was born in the corner.
In the corner. He doesn't care.
But just go with it. Puts him back in the corner. Okay. He's catching him, pushing buttons. Good block. Throws him out. I don't agree with that. Just throwing him back into the corner. Good block again. Tosses him back in the corner. Just go away. Playing pretty solid right now. Good block. Oh, gets hit. Try to hit a button on his wake up.
Yeah, I mean,
I believe that's what we also noticed the last match, was that he's pushing buttons a lot.
Yes.
In like situations, like he's holding up on block in certain, he's holding up during combos in certain situations, and he's pushing buttons on block, waiting for his turn.
Yep.
Which we're seeing evident now.
Wow!
Full screen, unblockable, overpower.
Oh, but you're going to get punished for that.
Yeah.
You turn counter break way too early.
You're not playing the same guy you were playing before. You were playing Ultra Arcade Specs.
You got to make sure you got that mental game on half.
Very true.
With teabag.
With teabag.
Oh, try.
Shadow counter,
but okay.
Just a little bit. He died. Oh, taunt. Just go with A, taunting. UA back.
Get caught by the skull. Okay.
Oh, overhead. All right, this is going to be the
stacking
start the basket pressure. All right, gets the skulls. Oh, pushes him into the corner. Run cancel manuals and, ooh, blows up the combo. Overhead. This is going to be it. Yep, Spectro Manual.
You stack the curses. The Saber Roll couldn't build meter. Didn't have to worry about the instinct because, well, it's already full. But it's there just in case he decides to pop it. It was a waste. The pressure that you get from base, he locks you down. And it's hard to find an opening. You really have to know the button timing specifically for Spinal, especially when he's plus on the medium skull. A lot of people get caught by that.
Very true. And just go there, got caught by some normal Spinal shenanigans right there.
Yep.
And just got hit and lost a lot of health.
And he really needs to just spend time blocking. So that could really help him out because look, you see him try to challenge every block stream.
Very true. He's very eager for his turn.
Yes.
Essentially. He really wants to hit buttons because I feel like that's what makes him the most comfortable in like all of these matchups. Is like I just need to like play my game and hit buttons.
And super early.
He's got the opportunity. Two heavies, big body damage on Bass.
Oh, missed it.
Lunge is over, but he's in the corner. Bass tosses him out. Overhead. Okay, skulls. Ooh, lockout. Good throw, got punished for his troubles. Ooh, skull. Ooh! Again, got a little bit too eager. If he had just waited another second for the block from the skull and then hit a button, he would have gotten the punish because probably Bass would have stuck out like a medium kick or something. If I had to speculate.
Yes. You're going to get anti-aired.
Really smart anti-air from that.
All these curses on Saberwolf, he's not going to build any meter until he starts hitting Spinal.
Alright. Bass taking control of the matchup. Lockout. Not going to take full advantage of it. Ooh, same side. Got hit on the dome, and this is going to be it. Yep, ultra. All right, that's going to be 2-0. UA Bass, one more game to take it against Just Go With A and put him into losers round three. Or winners round three, sorry. This is winners side of the bracket.
Yes.
All right, Just Go With A, like I said, needs to just calm down, take a moment, maybe breathe, and then know he's going to get right back into it. But he needs to just wait his turn.
Yeah, he's too eager to do something.
Right. All right, Bass going to capitalize on this lockout. Spectromano will get a skull, tossing towards the corner, gets four skulls. Oh, a little bit too early, still on hit stun. After that throw, Just Go With A tried to toss out. All right. Punches him towards the corner, backs up. Heavy lockout, big damage. Skull under again.
Wow. Yep, full skulls.
Full stock. Okay. Ooh, catches him low. Low again. Just Go With A needs to block his. Oh, he keeps getting hit. And he gets hit off the leaping slash via the skull.
Yep. Again, it goes back to the original Sabrewolves that we saw. You know, we saw them actually perform in neutral.
Right.
And this is totally different. You see what happens when Sabrewolf doesn't take advantage of his amazing buttons.
Very true. And it also shows how good Bass is to be controlling such a neutral heavy character so well with Simon. And that's going to be it. 3-0, UA Bass takes it over. Just Go With That.
Absolutely.
Crazy stuff. Well, not really. It's kind of expected. You kind of expect to see the same three faces in a KI top 8. You kind of expect to see Bass. You expect to see Nikki. And you expect to see Thompson when he shows up. But he's not here this weekend.
Right.
So, sad face.
Yeah. But next up, we do have Rotendo.
Rotendo.
I believe that's Insomnia's Rotendo. Or at least a player manager for Insomnia.
Yeah, I believe so.
And then, again, Circa Tubbleware.
Circa Tubbleware.
Tubbo.
Tubbo.
I do say Tubbo all the time. I know he doesn't like that.
I say Tubbo.
Tubbo? Tubbo or Tubbo?
I say Tubbo.
Tubbleware.
Like a tuba?
Yeah, tuba. I get
like
that.
A bump.
Yeah, yeah.
Bump.
But this is actually loser's round for pool K1 here at Frosty Fosting.
This is loser's round 3 as well.
Yeah, round 3. Excuse me.
So they're decently far in the bracket, which is pretty good to see.
Right.
I know we were running behind a bit.
Right. This was a 64-man bracket, I believe.
Ooh, I'm pretty happy about that. I didn't know we had 64.
We did have some last-minute entrants. Last I saw, they set it up for 64, and then there was some added. So I don't know if it broke beyond that.
Right. So very interesting. So we're going to be seeing Rash versus, I assume, Glacius?
He says he's been working on Fulgore.
Rotendo has. Okay. So that'll be interesting to see because I've never seen his Fulgore. I actually haven't seen Rotendo play that often. So this is just going to be a treat. And to see two players who have experienced in like various fighting games as well. I know Rotendo has played various fighting games before Killer Instinct. And Tubbo, of course, comes from Marvel and Street Fighter, the Capcom games. Which is why you saw him in the match where we did see him play a little bit rushed down as the Marvel background.
Yep.
But he was also content to play neutral, which is a Street Fighter background.
Absolutely.
So, be very interesting to see how Rotendo's fighting game background pours into Killer Instinct, as I've never seen it before. So, be interesting to see.
Yeah,
and
both
look forward to it.
Both players fundamentally sound. They do come from previous fighting games, so, I mean, hey. That's the thing about this game, you know, like Chris G played at Kuwait, Tennessee last year.
Right.
And then he was a player that was like, well, he doesn't really play this game. He's not going to know. You got to watch out for these guys because they have fundamental abilities.
Exactly.
That carry
and those
over
fundamentals carry over to every single game they play.
Indeed. And he did really well at Kuwait, Tennessee. I don't remember where he ended off that year, but he went really far. So
I think like top 16.
Yeah.
Probably.
Absolutely.
So definitely interesting. Because like all those players, like Justin,
look at
Eduardo, just coming back, is able to put in wins because he's so experienced in neutral and like he's picking a character that has every tool in Fulgore. So interesting to see Eduardo come back to the game or Pierre Balrog.
Especially pick up Fulgore.
Yeah.
Because he used to play Orchid.
Orchid, right. So Orchid in season 1 when he played.
And then I know Justin was talking about maybe coming back because he really likes the game. He really likes Killer Instinct and Skullgirls, but he's like, I don't know if I want to put like all of this time into learning a whole new game for a community that's essentially just a, well, which is essentially growing, still growing in person, but has essentially been relative, like, put on as an online community because a lot of our tournaments are online and all of those tournaments are super successful, like the 8-bit beatdown was when that was still going on.
And the KI Pro League.
And the KI Pro League when that was going on, and I'm sure this KI Pro League qualifier for the Killer Instinct World Cup are going to have 7 million people in them.
7 million, because that's how many players downloaded the game.
Damn right. Whew. Gosh darn. All right. Getting right into it. Pretend this is going to be a matchup. He's going to be trying to keep him at like a semi-medium but long long range.
Exactly.
And T-Boy is going to be looking to get in and eat all of his hail and get all this meter. So he can call his speeder back and get in. And
right.
You always drink out in bowl beams.
Heavy mix-up.
Very true.
Big cut. Shatter.
Nintendo catching him with everything right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh.
Shadow hail, get caught.
I really like that setup. Get the side switch into the hail, smart stuff. Oh, but that big boot is a big boot, and it's going to hit.
Ooh.
Ooh, the speedster delayed it, and it still hit. Nintendo was not blocking it.
Right.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, he's going to pull out. Okay. Is he going to be able to recover in time? No, he's not able to
quick hit. Shadow boot recapture.
Recapture.
Nice stuff, nice stuff.
Ooh, not going to be able to take advantage fully of that lockout, but gets a pretty good combo. And the throw. Good break of the medium juggle. Smart stuff. Hail's going to be out.
There we go.
Ooh, side switch. I don't think he wanted a side switch. I think he would have done. Keep pretending in the corner. But
right, yeah. Especially since it's Glacius.
Oh, projectile limbo. Smart stuff. Got the meter. And used it. And this is going to be the health bar yesterday.
It's cool. And more teabagging.
And more teabag. Tubuer, a very anti-teabag band troll, was like, yo, we do teabags here all day. Every day. Ooh, ate the hail. Full screen. Oh, try to use the tracking portal punch to get in, or puddle punch, sorry, to get in.
Right.
Just didn't work out. To where side switch going. Pretty flawless.
Good chip out.
Gets hit. All right. Glacius.
Ooh, the return teabag.
Ooh. I looked over at the player cam to look at Rosendo's face, and he showed no emotion.
Dead serious.
Just stone cold.
Just like Glacius.
Ooh, smart stuff. Gets in. Throws him into the corner. Oh, a little dance, a little shimmy. You know, like I said, Street Fighter player, doing a little bit of that shimmy.
Mm-mm. Get away with the New York Tims.
Ooh.
Stuffs
overhead.
Whatever Shadow Rotenda was hoping to do.
Oh, exchange enter, I don't agree with that, because it makes up, catches him low, and that's going to be it.
Watch the toes.
Watch the toes. I got steel toes in these Tims, B.
Ooh.
Gosh darn. Rotenda, you gotta pull. Gotta pull the 10, you gotta pull the size 10 Tim
off out them of toes.
You gotta pull the size 10 Tim out of Glacius' booty. Ooh, gosh darn. Oh. I don't know what Tim was doing. He just kinda walked under and started spinning there. Crazy.
So, woo! They let it rip.
Let it rip. Beyblade. Alright. A little bit of a hello my baby, hello my honey dance. A little bit of that can-can.
Oh, nice.
Oh, catches him with the heavy, but good break of the light.
Liquid eye. Smart, smart getting rid of the hail.
Punish. Mm-mm. Throw.
Wow.
No
really
tech.
Oh, my goodness.
You saw that he got locked out.
Yeah.
And he thought he might have dashed back in, so that's why Rotenda threw again. But got punished for his trouble. Smart stuff from Tubuware. That's why he's made it so far into this bracket. Is those adjustments and those reads,
knowing
how his opponent's going to react to that situation. Ooh, Nintendo uses the hail, very smart in that situation. Little dance for the liquid eyes. Ooh, punishes. He was an instinct, so he does have 5 hits of armor stock. He's got one right now. All right, he's going to call in the speedster. Ooh, but like I said, he's got the armor. The speedster didn't hit because the armor, well, it did hit, but like, yeah, like hit him out
right,
of the animation.
Yeah.
Because the armor. That throw's gonna kill. Smart stuff from Rotenda. We're doing a little dance. Doing a little Gligley dance. Recapture? Oh, just a little bit early, but catches him on the speedster.
Wake up and block. That's a hail setup.
Okay. Alright. Oh man, they're just content to play full screen. Tubuer does not need to go in right now. He's content to just eat all of his hail. you know, get the slushy, you know?
He's got all the meter.
Get all the meter, and he's going to punish it. Smart stuff. People were waiting until there was an opportunity, and got it. Smart stuff. All right. Ooh, throws him in the corner.
The slowest shatter ever. Oh, no, counter break. Why would you risk that?
That's a big risk, and it didn't work out for Tendo. Oh, and he hit a button, too. He thought, maybe if I throw out, like, a quick jab, my armor will take one hit, and my jab will come out, maybe hit him out of it. Not going to work out for you, Tendo. I like the idea, though.
Stand up, block. That's all you got
to
do.
Block it. You had to. Buck got hit for his trouble, and then the health bar. And now we're in game three, with Tubor up 2-0, and Rotendo on the verge of elimination. All right, gets in.
Nice.
A good break on those lights. Rotendo has been very on point breaking these lights today. All right, exchange enter, puts him in the corner, but puts himself back in there. Very odd.
Ooh,
ooh, but good counter breaker. It's going to be some big damage. He's going to have, yep, Shadow Cash out. Almost the entire first off rush.
Yep.
Great, great whip punish with the ram head. Just like put him in full screen. Smart.
Said you can't just throw hail up whenever you want.
Very true. Do a little bit of that teabag. You know, to where didn't like it. He was like, I'm gonna teabag all day or day. Like that Kanye West song, all day.
Ooh, because if on a hail, there was still one bouncer.
Ooh, shadow counter. Yeah, it's gonna work. The hail absorbed one hit, but not all of it. Ooh, what's the mix-up? All right, so just go for a same side. Jabs him out. Yep, punish. Good stuff. But gets broken on the lights. Rotendo very on point, breaking these lights again. Hail. All right, what's the mix-up?
Caught by the shatter. Gotta watch out for that light. Jump up, get away.
Very true. Do a little kick. Oh my good golly gumdrop. Hail, smart stuff. Punishes the Lickitung in.
Lickitung in.
No, that would have been much more fitting if Arcanine was playing.
Indeed.
All right, medium. Boots him. Drops the conversion. I would have won in the game. These jitters.
Oh, why? No break, but no punish. Oh, that's going to be it.
Rotendo.
Hit him with the size. Now it's a size 12 boot. That was a medium.
I think we're getting full ultra right now. Well, yeah, that's right. Because somewhere just lets it ride. He doesn't do anything extra.
Oh, what's Tubor? Oh, he's going to slap his chest. He's going to slap his chest. Gosh darn. Tubor is pumped. He's hyped.
He's really working hard at this game, to be quite honest. He's done a lot of work since what? Combo Breaker was really where he made his big first initial break.
It was his jump off point.
Yes.
It's where he's been. It's where he made his first big splash in the community. And now he's continuously grown.
Indeed.
And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we see him at the World Cup. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see him make it very far in the Killer Instinct World Cup last chance qualifiers. So, it'll be very fun. But he was rocking a stick, and you know, his stick looked very sick.
Very indeed.
And, you know, he's rocking some custom Sandwell parts, some custom Microswitch parts. Like, I am a big arcade stick aficionado, and I love the mesh ball tops. I love Microswitches. My personal favorite is I buy green switches in bulk, and I put them in those Sandwell parts.
Okay.
And so, like, I get that nice little tactile click from, you know, from, like, a green switch keyboard, which is very nice.
I was going to say, I personally use the Brooks converter for when I play Street Fighter V.
$35
for a converter of any console of your choice, pretty much, and play whatever game you want. There's no, like, 8-minute disconnect like some of these other converters have.
Very true.
And they are approved for Evo. So
very true. One of the only Evo-approved converters out there.
Yep,
so very true. So Naptown Clutch. Oh, boy. They got Killer Instinct there. It's going to be lit. It's brought to you guys. Brought to you guys by the awesome people over at KIT, NetBattles, Panda X Gaming. They've got Guilty Gear. They've got Melee. They've got KI. They've got Mortal Kombat X, KOF 14, Street Fighter V, the new Blaze Blue, Smash 4, and Ultimate Marvel versus Capcom 3.
Are you going to be able to breathe?
I don't know.
It's going on February 24th through the 26th. Be sure to register at smashgg.com/NTC.
Yes. Oh, and we were talking. We were talking about these shirts like before the stream even started. I see a sick Nakali Street Fighter V design, but I'm looking at this Akuma shirt like, yo.
Yo, personally, zero shirt for me? $5 off all these shirts. Are you using promo code FF9?
Are you saying if I use promo code FF9, I get 5% off all shirts collections?
Yeah, only if you go to creativeflame.com/FGC.com, $5 off their shirt collection.
Good golly gumdrops.
And but more like, clothes.
More clothes. You know, I'm a man who loves his clothes. And you know, Air Dash Club got you covered if you like that GDLK swag stuff.
God,
10% all merchandise with promo code Frosty2017. That's Frosty, all lowercase, 2017. They've got what looks like some sick hoodies and a godlike shirt. Gosh darn.
The anime reference is strong. But so, next up, we're going to be looking at
some godlike gameplay. We got UA Wheels, UA Dayton J versus Hollywood Flipside Tactics. Make you go to sleep. Gosh darn.
Oh, man.
I saw a sleep moving Wheels' chair, and I was like, collusion. I don't know if he was like trying to affect his view, but if that's a very dirty play, that's what's happening.
I don't know. That's really underhanded.
But obviously, Sleep being the nice guy he is, obviously just helping out, being a kind soul.
Absolutely. Now, Dayton's the one to look out for at this tournament.
Very true.
Remember, Dayton is not qualified for World Cup yet. But look at it this way, because I've been saying on Twitter myself, fourth or better at this tournament, odds are you're going to automatically qualify if the people who qualified do make top three.
That's true. And it's usually the same people who always do make top three.
Right, exactly.
But I want to bring your attention to this. Wheels and Sleep has already happened this week. They played in the recent Stream.me tournament.
Did they?
And you know who won?
Who won?
UA Wheels. Gosh darn.
Is that a precursor for something that's going to happen?
I don't know. Maybe that was just a read. They knew that they were going to be in similar pools because the pools were posted early. And maybe Sleep was like, I'm just going to hold a bunch of my tech.
Let me try to figure things out right now.
Yeah.
All right. This is actually for top eight.
This is a top eight qualifier. So
Wheels.
And this is winners as well.
Right. Wheels has taken a Tusk. Red. And we're going to see Sleep's Maya, the mayonnaise.
The mayonnaise on a cheeseburger.
This will be interesting.
This is going to be interesting. This is also the first time we're seeing Sleep's Maya today.
Yes, indeed.
Now, if you're not familiar and only know Sleep from his Arbiter and or Count Raw play, this is going to be a whole new world. I almost wanted the song there. Did it. But it's going to be a whole new world for you because this is Maya. This is some crazy stuff.
But on the other hand, we have Tusk,
who also does crazy stuff.
An underused character.
Very true.
In this scene.
Very true. Very underused.
He is terrifying.
He's got deflect windows. He's got some crazy wacky stuff. Like look at that. Like he's gonna turn around. He's gonna.
Ooh, that anti air though. You're gonna jump over? No, you're not.
He's gonna suplex you. Just like
Slice.
Brock Lesnar. Just like, gosh darn.
That sword. Oh, wow. Duck under that. The reaction timing for that. Insane. Look.
Good punish though.
Good try.
All right. Sleep. Looking to take advantage of this now. He's got the momentum now.
Think about it.
He's going to be able to take advantage and capitalize with it.
That was only, what, 2-3 combos that Tusk had? And they were like four hits?
All right. Recapture. Yep. Alright, Sleep going to cash out. Yeah, he's going to be doing damage under yet. Alright, he's going to backdash, trying to get his dagger back. But he's going to spirit step.
Cut.
Smart stuff from Wheels.
Oh, the stagger, he drops it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shadow. He couldn't.
No, he didn't have shadow.
He didn't have neither shadow counter. He had to take the chip. Couldn't really do anything in that situation.
Even if he did shadow counter, he probably could have canceled it.
Very true. He was an instinct.
Yes. Tusk has an instinct that's pretty much barrel cancel on crack.
It allows you to cancel, essentially, for at least a chunk of your instinct. It allows you to cancel any special into any special. Crazy. Wacky stuff. And so it allows Tusk to do such insane stuff as we've been seeing so far.
That sword, it's terrifying.
Very good. It's like,
what a range.
What a range. It's a very large sword.
Yes, I mean, you look at Tusk, you're like, well, he's a real slow character.
Right.
But with these
normals he has, that cover essentially 35% of the screen.
And deflect window, so you try to challenge that button. Oh, you're... That adds damage on top of the damage the button already does.
Very true. Oh, he's going to be able to punish this. Catches him with the spirit step into it. Smart stuff. He is an instinct, so he's going to cancel.
Ooh.
Dropped it. Oh, try to spirit step through the dagger, but look, it's
got, okay.
Ooh, the raw jump
Link
punch.
Oh no.
That's one of those counterbreaker situations where you can't counterbreak before the move actually hits. So it's one of those instances where, since it's a true follow-up, the opponent can, I believe, lock out before you're technically able to counterbreak.
Right.
Like what happens with Gargos' portal punches. If you want to read more about that, Infulment, the person who makes the Killer Instinct guide, did a huge post about it on the official Killer Instinct forums on ultra-combo.com/forums. It's one of the pinned posts under game discussion and feedback. Check it out, and you'll learn more about it. Have a better understanding of combo breakers. But getting back into this game, Wheels looking to get back into it and pushing Sleep back into the corner. Stomp it on him.
He dashed on him 3 times.
Suplex City. No follow. Ooh. Sleep gonna throw smart stuff. He's got both of his daggers. Can't shadow counter.
Cannot. He's gotta hold that. Okay, jab. Ooh. Blocks it, baits it out like that.
It's gonna be some big damage when he started off with that heavy punch.
Ooh.
Oh, but he's gonna get broken.
Terrifying.
Ooh! Wow. But uses the Hellbreak!
Wow. That did out. You see the chunk of life he took from him?
Oh man. I'm so upset he didn't convert up the Helmbreaker.
He made one mistake, and that was, what, 20%?
Okay.
He doesn't have to carry anymore.
Oh, he's going
to
try to DP. Oh, but it's going to trade. That's going to end the health bar.
Yep.
All right. Ooh, just one in throw. Smart stuff. Sleep.
Oh, good punch.
Oh, he's tapped out. Kind of a weird situation for both players.
Right,
kinda,
absolutely.
Kind of seemed like a very big scatter.
Yeah.
Neither player knew what was exactly
Ooh,
going on.
Boom! Another one!
But Dayton knows exactly what's going on right now as he's taking his life bar away. Alright, overhead. Not gonna work out. Heavy. Alright, let's mix up. Ooh, dash over.
Oh, good shadow counter.
Good shadow counter from Dayton. Or Wheels, sorry. Alright, trying to check him with these buttons. Alright, sleep. Using the shadow bar to make that save.
Ooh!
Save.
Yep, right into the tumble.
Killed? No, it's not. Dash back. The mix up spirit step, yep. What's up? Sleep is trying to get his dagger.
Oh no, this is
gonna
be
lockout. This is gonna be it. No!
No!
Yeah, he's gonna
get it.
Ooh, okay. He could have ended it with the DP ender. Opted to go for a much longer. Much more convoluted combo.
He didn't want to. He wanted to roll on him. Except me.
He wanted to show the world what he was made of. That is what he did. Both players looking very calm. I think Sleep went back to character select. I don't know if he's going to opt to pick Arbiter, because I feel like Arbiter might do better in that matchup, because he's able to, instead of getting around with projectiles, he's able to get around with his normal sword and stuff. So maybe he wants to do that. Maybe he just wants to take a breather, just chill. Both very plausible. So it looks like he is going back to Maya.
Right. It might be just the fact that Sleep doesn't know what to do against Tusk. Like, obviously he knows the character, but how often do you fight a Tusk?
I mean, they just played this week in tournament.
It's true. So he has a tape, and if you review the tapes, you're definitely going to win.
Very true. If you looked at how you were losing and why you were losing, you should, relatively speaking, be able to improve and be able to therefore beat the person you were there for, then were unable to beat.
Theoretically. You should be able to do that. But we're going back with mayonnaise in Tusk.
Rocking that cybernetic mayonnaise. Try to run and throw. Sleep try to make the hard read in that situation. Doesn't really work out for her.
All right.
Crowd thuggery.
We heard some thuggery going on. But wow.
Okay. All right. Misses the anti-air.
Oh, the deep luck window works in his favor. Sorry, wheels his favor. Gets the cat. Oh, it's going to get locked. That's going to be big damage.
Right.
I had like three thoughts and like one right there. I don't know if you caught that. Crazy.
Okay, here we go. All
right. Going to go for the follow up? No. I'm going to go for the mix-up. Oh, caught some with daggers, but not able to convert. He's going to move for this time. Yes, he is. Oh, but gets broken on the medium. Spirit step in. Throw. Smart stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can't shadow counter that. Can't check him either. Oh, but good punish from Wheels. That DP has such a huge range because the sword is so large.
It's insane.
All right, what's Slap going to be able to do? Oh, overhead. Oh, no conversion from Wheels. That's the key. Oh, recapture. What a situation. Good breaking the light, though, from Wheels. All right, go low. No, off to go for the Helmbreaker. DP. No conversion. Ooh, 2, 3, 4, 5. He can't. Oh, he might have actually been able to do a special cancel off that because he was an instinct.
Right.
Oh, but he's going to check him on that. Smart stuff. Spirit steps in.
Doesn't care that you DP'd. He said, this is my shoulder.
My shoulder? Gosh darn.
It's tattooed.
It's tattooed. I was in the chair for 3 minutes. That's how long it takes to get tattoos, right? As a guy who doesn't have a tattoo and is a child, I expect tattoos to take 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It might have been a temporary tattoo, to be sure, like, to be fair. But, like, I don't know. I think Tusk is, like, one of those people who's, like, he did it to himself. Like a mirror. Oh, good counterbreaker.
This is going to be very important for sleep.
Yep, catches out, smart stuff. Don't get greedy.
Ooh. Oh, okay, okay.
Great blocks from sleep.
Oh, no, he can't because instinct.
Exactly. Oh, wow. He can't end it.
Wow. Oh, the gamble. Oh,
my good golly gumdrop. That neutral dump.
Yeah.
Yeah, should have stayed on the ground there. You knew
Don't
it was
move.
Coming.
Tusk is at that range. Don't.
Because he can DP you on a reaction. If you jump right in front of him, you're going to DP it.
He doesn't even need to DP. He's just like, okay. Sword in the air.
Sword in the air.
Swords.
Swordsman. Sindar. Mayo.
Wow. Maya again.
All right. Sleep sticking out with Maya. All right. Ooh, gets caught with that heavy punch.
Oh, and stagger.
Oh, good breaking the light. Manual, though. Caught low. Wheels doing a really good job of converting all these openings he's been given. Sleep gets thrown for his trouble, and that's going to kill.
Wow.
Damn, Sleep did not look happy there.
I mean, he's getting hit by a truck and ran over.
Oh, and he's going to be able to. That's a decent trade.
Missed the grab.
Okay. Up, jumping all around.
Getting punished for trying to anti here.
All right, back dash. No. DP? Yep. Wheels opted not to go for the follow up and just did one DP, which I respect. No follow up again. Try to catch him pushing a button. He's going to be able to cancel out, so Sleep can't shadow counter for fear of getting hit.
Right?
Oh, good crouching heavy punch.
This is going to.
Wow. Suplex City, Brock Lesnar, what are you doing? Oh, what an unfortunate series of events.
What was he gonna do?
Doogie Howser, what are you gonna do? What an unfortunate series of events.
What are you gonna do in that situation? It's
The DP puts him a little bit too far forward. Wheels jumps over him with Tusk. Wow.
Just oh man. I mean, especially when you're in the corner with Tusk.
Yeah.
We're talking, he doesn't even have to be in your face.
He's got
the sword there. Up a quarter of the screen.
A quarter.
At the very least, it pretty much takes up half the world.
Half the world. Very true. You know, when we were testing Tusk at IG, that sword was the entire screen. It was the entire... We essentially... Here's what we did. Capcom was like, yo, here's the PC port of Marvel vs. Capcom 3. We've had it made for 3 years. Here it is. Just rip Virgil and make him Tusk. And I was like, boy.
That sounds awful. That sounds awful. I would never, ever want to face that. And
well,
here we are.
And here we are.
That was some... Wow, Tusk. I mean, who would have thought? One of two Tusks that I know of off-rip that actually main Tusk. I mean, of course, Rico Suave used Tusk. At Texas Showdown.
One of the Tristan brothers uses Tusk.
Yes,
you know?
Yep.
Not the Tristan brothers, the Shin brothers.
Shin Paulo.
Paulo and Tristan. Those guys. Shout out to those guys. I know Tristan has been playing Tusk, and I haven't, I'm not 100% sure about Paulo. I think he's just mainly been sticking with Thunder. But... Yeah, there are a handful of Tusk players, but you don't. It's a character you don't see often.
Yes,
he's a challenging enough character as it is already.
Now, next up, we're going to have Ultra Arcade's Bass versus Blue Hurricane Amenti, and they requested one of these two requested a blind pick.
Very interesting.
So both players. All right, so let's go down the list, and this is a top eight qualifier winner's side for Pool K2. So Bass has Spinal, Cinder, Mira, Jago, and could pull out a Shadow Jago.
I have a very interesting relationship with Amenti.
Okay.
Because one, I'm the co-founder of VH. I was in the room when J Mart created it, and we were coming up with names. I told him who to pick up. I told him to pick up Grief. I told him to pick up all those guys. But I have a very interesting relationship with Amenti because me and him were coworkers for a long time at Iron Galaxy.
Right, that is true. There's some history.
So I could safely say Amenti can also pull out almost every Season 3 character.
That's true because we've seen what? Gargos?
Gargos, Idol.
Idol, yeah.
I know he's played a lot of Idol. Omen, Maya, Jago, Rash, Mira, if you didn't already say Mira.
I mean, he's got a lot.
He's got a lot of boys.
Yeah.
He's played Arbiter in the past. He's got a repertoire. But we'll be right back. We're waiting for these guys to come back. I'm actually going to go run over to Amenti. I'm going to say, get your booty on the stream. But we're going to be right back after these ads. We will see you in a hot second. Stick around, guys.
All right, welcome back, guys. I'm joined by Zero Syndicate still because he's the boy, and I'm the boy, Wonder, and we're back. It's Frosty Fostings. We're going to have Bass versus Amenti. This is a top eight qualifier, and it's also a blind pick. So
whoa!
I don't know.
No,
I don't know if
no eyes.
Been, I don't no eyes. I don't know if you've been as curious as me in this commercial break, but I heard some side betting, some betting of some KI gold of if they're blind picking.
I'm gonna bet,
but I'm just Josh.
My Oracle Guardian.
I'm going to bet my gold Gargo skin.
Gah!
I'm gonna bet the Terror Pack.
Ooh, the Terror Pack.
The costume skin. I'm going to bet a gold pack.
Okay, gold pack.
Which, you know, is available now in the Microsoft Store. Some cosmetics for your Killer Instinct boys.
You know what else is
girls.
Available on the Microsoft Store?
What?
Season 2 of Killer Instinct is
for
currently
free.
Free.
For
games
free?
For gold. Free. So if you don't have Killer Instinct and you want to get into it, check it out. Season 2 is free. We're talking that second row of characters see on the character select screen. All yours.
I mean, like, who? I mean, you've got TJ Combo, you've got Maya, you've got Kanra, you've got Riptor, you've got
Omen.
You've got Rockman, the Rock Lobster,
Broccoli
himself,
Man,
Rock,
well.
Brock Lesnar, Aganos, you've got Aria,
Hisako,
you've got Hisako, she's a spooky little girl.
And let's not forget the Fireman himself, Cinder.
Cinder! And this is going to be a season 2 battle. It looks like Bass had picked Cinder. Amenti had picked Maya.
I figured Amenti would do Maya. It seems an Amenti pick.
And I feel like picking Cinder in the blind pick is the safe pick.
Yes.
Because you know they're either going to try to counter your main or your Trinitary character, which is just like something that like I've noticed.
Yeah.
Because you always try to lose counter the main or like dead. They're going to right back into it. BH Menti is trying to start off pressure really soon, but Bass is able to counter really easily. Bass, chilling, is able to try to keep spacing. Ooh, gets punished. BH Menti is going to be able to do a full combo. Recapture. Goes back to stagger back. Oh, but gets punched in the face. Oh no, good throw from Bass. Ooh, recapture combo. Alright.
See, that's smart. So doing a juggle combo, which does little damage, recap put him into auto double combos.
Very true. And it also helps with the scaling of the combo as well.
Yes.
Scales a little bit less. I'm correct. It could be right. Oh, try to catch a low, but that's going to stack a lot of PV. And with these new PV changes, that's going to stay for a good hot minute. Good hot minute. Get it?
It's on fire.
He's on fire. Pop? Yep, there it is. Pop goes the weasel. All right, fast look to get in. Good tech from Menti, though.
Oh, nice.
Conversion, oh, but drops it just a little bit too
tried
far.
Tried to do anti-air, it was a little bit early. It was still smart.
Very true. All right. Another good tech throw. These guys are teching everything right now. All right. Dagger. Good DP. Ooh,
missed.
Oh, just no, a little bit too close. That DP does send Maya just a bit forward, as we saw. Versus
right.
Sleeper's Wheel at the very end. That last third game. Oh, he's gonna get punched? No, activate Sensei, try to backdash. He is. He can't trailblaze a little bit too far to get that one chance.
He jumped both with that. He's smart as well.
Overhead, good block. Ooh, trying to shadow counter. A little bit too early. Smart instinct activation for Bass. That's Cinder and Sadira, I believe, are the only two characters that can activate instinct in the air.
I think right there, they just wanted to end. They burn out Ender. So we'll carry over in the next round, build some potential damage, but he dropped there, surprisingly.
Shame. Like the new day. Shame. Alright, Menti controlling spacing right now very well with these daggers and these normals. Very smart stuff.
Absolutely.
Stuffed his wake up. I think Bass tried to hit a bunch of stuff by smart stuff. There's so much stuff. I'm saying
there's
stuff.
A lot of stuff
so
in
much.
This.
There's a lot of stuff in care.
Oh,
great shadow counter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Alright, oh, okay. Opted to go for a shorter combo. Oh, but he's looking to go with these dagger combos.
Aren't you holding on to just a little bit of health still in the first life bar?
Very true, but it looks like, yep.
Oh, there we go.
Yep, over.
See, complicated curse, sorry.
Is he going to try to carry him to the other side? He tried to, maybe, but unsuccessfully. Menti's going to be able to get his dagger back relatively easily.
Menti's definitely blocking low for sure. Every time that base is tried to go through the low inferno,
it's blocking.
Yeah.
Smart stuff. And it really shows that he knows this matchup.
Yes.
He at least has some expertise in this matchup. So I don't know if this was the correct counter kick that MMT wanted, but if it was, it proved to be the right choice. And if it wasn't, well, he got lucky.
So it was MMT that called for the blind pick.
I have no idea. But
okay,
I'm
we don't know.
It was.
You're not
worthy. I'm assuming it was.
Way. Yeah, it probably was.
Because people really only consider MMT playing two characters, and that's Mira and Maya. But Cinder, but Fast is a multitude of characters. So I would assume that MMT
right.
would have called for it. Or Fast is called for it. One of the two.
Good blocks.
Alright. Good conversion from Dementi.
It's a good start for base this time around.
For sure. Very good. But he started out strong last game as well. Yeah. He had the life lead until a big shifting point in the last in that second game. Or that first game, right?
Oh, fired up Inferno. Nothing off of it.
Dagger combo. We can see a Mantis. No. We can see a sweet hard knockdown. Try to catch him on his wake up in a fight. A sweet hard knockdown again. Let's mix up.
Oh, no.
He's going to get a bomb stack on. The bomb's going to go away now because he got hit.
Jab, nice throw.
Mix up, top of bomb, clap! Stacks him. Oh, this is just gonna do some normal damage.
Ooh!
Ooh! Because, alright, so that happened because her shadow counter is relative to where the character is on screen.
Right.
So if you're not advancing forward in any way or backwards, she's not gonna move.
Okay, alright. That makes sense, thank you.
No problem. Ooh, they just stare down.
Makes it safe with instant cancel.
Oh,
okay.
Good block. Alright, toss the dagger in the air.
Yep.
The unbreakable unblockable track. Dagger came out. Mantis. Combo tapped out. Health bar is almost even now.
Potential damage up with that Inferno. Good. Oh,
good tech. These guys are playing super smart right now.
Absolutely.
Ooh, trying to shadow counter.
Okay.
Gets thrown for his troubles, Bass. Taking that first health bar with 53 seconds left on the clock. Ooh, gets caught for the overhead from Cinder. Mantis, what's he gonna do with his health bar? Try to throw, gets tech. Unbreakable. No, unblockable, I'm sorry. Alright, Mantis. Doesn't really have to make up too much ground, but he's still down in the life bar. And I think he's, yep, made it back now. Dagger toss. Okay, mix up, try to go for a normal throw.
Ooh.
Throw. Alright, press the bomb. Mix up. Throw, good stuff. Oh, burn out. They're gonna burn out the arms. It's gonna burn every time she tries to throw a dagger. Oh, but it's gone.
Ooh. Trying to perhaps catch them all rolling.
Maybe.
One.
Ooh, gets TP. But he's not gonna be able to follow up because of the hitbox is that hit behind.
Loose the shadow can help.
Oh, short combo, another one chance or two chance break there for Menti.
Oh, let's see. It's okay.
Okay.
Well, combo started.
Well, combo.
Burn out the arms again. Make you think twice about throwing them daggers now.
Very true. I think this is what Bass wants. He has the momentum right now. And this is going to be it. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so Bass, once he got the momentum, he was very confident. He was able to keep it. Able to get Menti into the corner. Able to keep the daggers at bay, because that's what's been really screwing up Bass, is those daggers and like the spacing that the spacing advantage that MMT had because of. But now Bass is looking like he's able to play his game and it's working out for him. See what if MMT can adjust to Bass can adjust.
Yeah.
Oh, catches him. Good end here. Daggers. Oh, no DP. Opts to go for a hard knockdown. Okay.
Oh, see? Oh, wow.
Thrum, but he, all right, this is good. He's going to burn him out. Or burn out his arm, sorry.
Right.
Her arm. Sweep, hard knockdown. This mix up runs away. MMT does have the life lead, so he doesn't need to go in. Doesn't need to get a little bit too...
Oh, wow.
Tosses him.
Yep.
All right, now into the corner. Kind of, I guess Bass likes to play a little bit of the center more than keeping his opponent mid-screen
right.
rather than keeping his opponent in the corner. Applying constant pressure.
Right, exactly.
This is working out for Mentee right now with the unbreakable block roll. That's a hit. She's going to try to recharge her dagger pips almost immediately now with the instant. So she's going to be able to get these daggers back. Anti-air is going to work. All right, toss her daggers. Break the tracking dagger. Nice. It's gonna kill with the Mantis. As again, came back in season 3, Mantis combos. Lit. Okay.
Heavy.
Good break. I was like, is he gonna break that?
Yeah. Or was it gonna get countered?
Especially at this level, it's such a risk to break heavy. You don't know if your opponent's gonna counter break or what.
I think it's a matter of seeing what you can get away with.
Right. Ooh, I think Bass thought that I was only gonna hit twice in the blockable window, or the breakable window, but I hit three times in the so good awareness. But Bass is gonna end the health bar anyway, and then he's now down. But still a very relatively close match between both competitors. Bass just has a very slight advantage. I mean, Aventi has a very slight advantage.
Right, right.
Got one back.
She's only got one, so she's not going to be able to throw out the track. Well, she has the tracking dagger, but she's not going to be able to throw out the unblockable dagger. Alright, so we got there. See, let's go for no recap, let's go for a bomb. Let's see. Checking her low. Make sure that, and then she's blocking his legs. His lower body, excuse me.
Right, yeah.
His legs. How do you block
lower
your legs?
Lower extremities.
Okay, dagger combo, Mantis, yep, cash out. Put him in the danger zone.
Yeah, that's gonna be good.
Ooh, good block. Oh, Mantis next up. Rolls in. No!
Okay, go with the bomb.
You have very little, I think, if any, info on that AP.
Yeah.
Ooh, the break!
Alright, it's a mix up.
Oh, this come on.
For the bomb throw. You just hate to see that thing happen. You're not worthy. Look at the abs that she has. Her stomach goes into itself.
She's a huntress. Of course she's got abdomen of steel.
You know, T-Swag recently lost a lot of weight.
T-Swag talking third person now.
T-Swag lost a lot of weight recently.
Can you tell? Please acknowledge this.
Can you tell from Combo Breaker when I had a fat face to now when I don't have a fat face?
Gosh darn. Alright, Amenti getting right back into it, putting the constant pressure that Amenti has been known to put on UA Bash right now.
Caught.
Good conversion. He's going to catch that. Yes, he is. Almost evening up the health bars. Good break from that. No AA.
Uh-oh.
Amenti has been jumping in for free a lot.
Yeah.
Fast looking at that and being like, I can adjust to that. And like, there's no AA.
Or Nero Time's gonna throw a fit.
He's gonna mess me up. He's like, yo, AA more.
Yo, you could have AA more.
Yeah, you know. That's always the gameplay advice you give. Like, AA more.
Yeah, you should probably.
Damn.
Recapture.
Alright, gonna burn out the arm. Smart stuff. He's gonna throw a bomb right over Maya.
Well, anywhere you go, go ahead, backdash. I'll blow you up. Go ahead, jump at me. I'll blow you up.
Alright, Cinder, if Cinder had meter, he could have cashed out all that PB that he had built up during that, like, exchange. So he had essentially, it was 20%, but because he didn't have meter during the throw, he's unable to do it. Sad.
It's interesting to see they started to do an air-to-air, the in-air shadow fight.
For Trailblazer?
Yeah, no, the shadow bomb. It was, I guess, he tried to capture Menti with that bomb in the air and then explode it, have his way, but went over. I feel like that was a wasted meter. Maybe could have been saved.
It's one of those situations where it's like, you're damned if you do, you're damned.
Right, absolutely.
Alright, good block. But now Maya has full daggers. Sure, this is going to end the health bar. There, you're at least eating one opening from these unbreakable and blockable daggers.
Unless
what?
A miracle happens. Oh. I thought something was going to happen.
Well, I guess
where
technically.
He was going to throw it. And he's got no daggers, so.
Well, he's got no daggers
and
now.
On
so.
Opposite ends, we got a 7-10 split going.
7-10 split with daggers. She got one back. She got the hold of one back. Oh, no ender, though. Can't get rid of that. GG. Next up. Oh, the track is, like I said.
Yep,
it's better to be in the air because you're not going to be able to build up as much damage, but it's still a considerable amount of damage.
Right.
It's
yeah.
Like 50% MO. If you're just starting it off wrong. Alright. That's pretending. Trying to stay in the same, like, trying to stay mid-range in the zone.
Right.
He's
comes left while still keeping Amenti at bay. And Amenti is just not letting that happen. And is just playing really well right now. Ooh. This could be it. Oh!
But he's still alive. He's been in the
same Oh, but he used the dagger and he punished it. Amenti moves on and makes top eight winner's side.
Okay. But next up, though.
My heart.
I know my heart because Bass has been in that situation. I was going to say, Bass has been in this situation before where he's at, you know, one hit away from death. Comes back. He revels in that moment and just something clicks where he's like, no, I'm not losing today.
He's going to activate the Wong factor.
But we'll see what happens. Hopefully, we see him back
in top eight. And he's still in losers, of course.
Yeah, so he's still surviving. But speaking of losers.
Yes. Next up, we have everyone's favorite Pokemon. Level 45 Arcanine versus everyone's favorite
Soup Man. He used to sleep.
He used to play Conra.
Used to.
I guess.
Anyways, what we're getting to is flip side tactics.
Flip side zone sleep versus level 45 Arcanine. It's gonna be lit.
Yeah.
I just wanna say this, that Amenti has had the same backpack since he worked at IG and since I first met him.
Oh wow.
He's had the same backpack. Amenti, step your backpack game up, man. Real rap.
But so remember what I said earlier. Last year Arcanine made top 8.
That is true. But also last year I made top 8 and now look where I am.
And sleep made
I'm
top
right
8.
Here.
Oh, that was grand final, wasn't
it? That was
it?
Grand finals. It was me versus sleep. I took one game off as Conra.
We
I broke a pair of headphones here. I did.
You bought them the same day.
I bought them the same day.
Oh,
boy. All right.
We're going to be looking at Sabrewulf coming from level 45 Arcanine, and then...
Probably Arbiter and or Maya. Probably Maya. I think
I don't know if you would bring Maya out for this situation because
I think at least for a game, Sleep is going to pick Maya. At least for a game, because honestly, if you want my 100% unbiased, honest opinion, Sleep is not going to respect level 45 Arcanine on the same level he would respect an Amenti, a Bass, or another player.
Which is why I would say like that he would not pick Maya in this match.
No, but I think he would because he's not going
to
respect the opponent as much.
If
he's like, I'm going to pick my secondary. I can do what I want. I'm the villain of Killer Instinct.
But that's the thing is that Maya is not his secondary.
Right.
He's making the evil switch to top tier.
Wait. He's saying he wants Maya to be his new main? Is that what you're saying?
I feel like that's what he's going to do. That's what he keeps talking about. You know what? I'm sick of playing characters that get nerfed.
I'm going to pick this girl. This delinquent.
This female warrior.
This female ninja warrior.
Female power.
I love Ninja Warrior. I've been watching a lot of the older reruns of it. I've like...
Okay.
Oh my god. It's so good.
If we're talking Japan,
like the stuff they would show on G4 Ninja Warrior.
Okay. Alright. That stuff is good.
It's so good.
I was going to say, if you're talking American Ninja Warrior, you can get out, right?
Oh, yeah.
You don't belong
here. Not that ABC stuff.
I've been training for this Ninja Warrior competition for years. No, there's Joe Schmo in Japan out there. He's balancing a broomstick on his hand. That's actually a different show. That's not Ninja Warrior.
Right. But, you know, like, you were saying that, like, you know, I want to talk about the Ninja Warrior stuff.
Okay.
Maya. I also think Maya could 100% complete the Ninja Warrior course in, like, 10 seconds. Because see how fast she rolls? Gosh darn.
Buff.
But, like, if you look at the patch notes for Season 3, she's been getting hit a lot recently.
Okay.
So, for Sleep to come in thinking, I'm going to pick up this character with, like, she's never going to get nerfed. Not the case, my friend. Not the case. Sleep's going to have a rough road ahead of him if that's the mindset that he's taking.
Maybe that's a game plan right there. Every character he plays gets nerfed.
So maybe
he's the hero that KI doesn't deserve.
Gosh darn.
But the hero that KI needs.
Gosh darn. Idol. All right.
This is going to be insane. Idol. I haven't seen this Idol.
Level 45 Arcanine. Rocking Idol. That Idol. versus that mayonnaise. Like, what did I say? What did I say? I told you.
You did. You were right.
I'm surprised.
You're surprised. That's fine to be surprised.
You know what? It is Loser's side, so he's not messing around anymore.
You're right.
And this idol, well,
this idol hasn't gotten anything started yet.
There is nothing started, but once idol gets started, let me tell you, here we go.
And it's about to get started.
Boom.
Boom.
What do you do?
It got okay. I would have done something after
that. Another DP is what I would have done.
He's a little bit late on that recapture. He's going to recapture off that situation.
Here we go. Ooh.
A little bit late.
He's trying.
Third time's the charm. He's got one more try in this. All right, he's going to throw.
Yep.
Okay.
Here we go.
Trying to get some low. Didn't really work out for him.
Good DP. He's the late one.
Low mage.
Put
look at this. Seems like, what do I do?
Oxy is the launcher, Andrew.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. I respect that.
Just get screen. Away from me. Okay.
Ooh, uses the cage to deflect it.
Try to use the stop.
That's similar. You've never seen that before?
No, I haven't.
It's some cool stuff.
Okay.
You can block a lot of projectiles with it because you can do it almost on reaction. Like,
right.
Just the
okay.
Very fun.
That's interesting.
Okay. All right, unbreakable, unblockable. Recapture. Oh, it's a little bit too high.
Oh,
that's gonna trade. All right. Okay.
I don't know about this pick. Maybe he picked idol just because he was worried about the player.
Maybe. Maybe he was worried about Arbiter and thought maybe idol's
maybe.
A better counter pick to him.
Maybe.
But no, like once he saw that Sleeve was gonna pick Maya, it's like he just switched the table if that's your thinking behind him. I don't know why he's hitting himself. That was removed a long time ago. Hitting yourself in instinct no longer extends instinct time. That was gone after the launch of idol, the patch after 3.1.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
Yeah.
That was...
Yeah, I mean, like...
That was an oversight.
I mean, like, who tested that?
Yeah, tested that?
I mean, like, who tested that?
Look, if you weren't done, you could have said something.
Yeet!
Fire!
Oh, boy.
Fox the Cloud, fire!
All right. Hollywood Sleep, just controlling this matchup like
yeah.
this. Level 45 Arcanine, putting on a little bit of damage.
See, Sleep is a little bit familiar with this matchup because locally we do have an idol.
Ooh, really?
Yeah, and he got some pretty crazy stuff.
Ooh.
I mean, he's helped me prep for this matchup myself.
That's pretty good.
And it's just a crazy matchup regardless.
Well, idol's a crazy character.
Yeah, exactly.
So. Oh, used the jump cancel from the warrior charge he had to evade what was a multi-hitting move.
Right. Okay.
Launch render, no DPM stuff. Oh, good block. He showed us his little butt.
He showed
did
us
you
the
see
back.
That?
He showed his backside.
He
did a Leo
backdash. I don't know if anyone ever noticed it, but I don't got a cute butt. I don't got a cute butt.
He's working on them squats.
He's got good glutes.
He got caught in a counterbreaker. This is really going to pay off for Sleep.
Yeah. Sleep. Toss out a dagger.
What's going to catch? Nothing. But get stomped.
Get stomped for your troubles.
Yeah.
Good block. Shadow counter? Can't. He's on the meter. Oh, get blocked out. It's going to be that. Oh, it's not. Didn't extend the combo far enough.
Ooh,
almost got hit by the meteor.
Crushed by a stone from the sky.
Just like the dinosaurs. Ooh, the hitbox on that. Just a little bit behind that heel. She rocking
the
high heels. She's got like the very back of his head.
It's a stage dive.
Oh. All right, heavy.
Oh, trying to get the lockout.
Try to manual the linker after the instinct animation, too. That was a weird choice to Sleep. All right. Mage stance. Tried to backdash. Gets hit by the cage. Good break on the medium, though. Oh, this is full screen.
That's it.
No, it's not.
Not it, but...
Oh. Tracking. Oh, tried to go for the recap. It doesn't work. Ooh, hits him out of the teleport. The only teleport that's, I think, a wake up in that stance is back, and that sends you like nowhere. Oh, kicks him low.
Oh, missed it.
Oh, he's gonna DP, light DP, light DP. Yep.
Oh my goodness.
And he hit it! And he hit the recapture.
He practiced it just to make sure he's got it ready for the next round.
Just to make sure. Oh boy.
Okay, what's gonna happen? Is Sleep gonna change characters? I don't think he needs to.
He doesn't need to? But if he's more confident in it, he might like.
Right, yeah. I mean, Arcanine.
I mean, the match.
A solid showing with idol.
Right.
But I'm. Well, I don't know. It's an interesting pick because I would expect him to pick Saberwolf. But I would love to find out what he's so worried about to make this decision. So, Sleep going in.
Yeah, character select.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, the match that we did see Sleep's Arbiter. His Arbiter was playing on point.
Right.
And then the match he lost was with Maya. He's trying to pick Kilgore.
Is he, though?
I heard the when you try to pick a character that you can't buy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh boy. It's Garbo.
I don't like this.
Garbos.
I would rather... I think Idol takes this, though.
I agree. No. All right. So I agree. In close range and mid range.
Yeah.
But at full screen, that's a kind of a hard matchup.
Yeah.
Unless Idol's a mage stance for Idol to win, in my opinion.
Right. No, I would agree.
Because a Gargus is just going to keep you out. And once you get in, he's going to summon a minion. And he's going to do his stuff.
But then I can teleport KO. That was a low blow.
So you can try to teleport, but like I'm going to punish you for it. Because the recovery on that's so long.
Oh,
ooh, my goodness. Gets the backdash. Arcanine did. Oh, gets the punish.
Ooh.
Oh, the recapture. Okay.
Ooh, the break stuff. Oh, in the main stance. Okay.
Ooh, catches him low. Catches the backdash.
Oh, my gosh. Really good.
Portal punches. Ooh, command grab. Sends him up to the sky. Psycho.
Wants to be the very best.
Like no one ever was.
But he's getting scooped.
And that is the test.
And now defeating
the minion is your cause. Gargos, man.
You gotta catch him.
You gotta catch him.
Jump catch. Oh, okay, you caught him there.
Jump catches out of the Rekka.
Okay. Oh, right. You could have gone for more.
Oh, but he is an instinct, so he's gonna get a recapture off this. No break on it, though. Ooh.
Wow,
So I actually have played Sleep in this matchup. And, like, it was actually your place after you, McCall.
Yep.
And he said that he has no idea what his moves look like. Because no one plays the character.
Crazy.
So, like, you're going to see a lot of Sleep kind of misbreaking and breaking a lot of, like, the wrong things.
Right. We'll get scoops.
Oh, gets him low again.
Now, this is where it gets crazy. You got two minions. They're both right. Never mind.
And they're both dead. We have two minions, and now they're in.
Commentator's curse.
Oh, catches the black dash. Oh, pretty bad. Arcanine's got a block. He's got to wait his turn. Ooh, claps him with the wings. All right. Gonna activate instinct. Ooh, that's not gonna work. You have to wait for the second hit for that lightning bolt to come out. That was only on the first hit.
Okay, we're in danger. It's tough road ahead. Tough road.
Oh, I thought it was over. It looked for a second. It looked like the health bar went away for a second.
Yeah.
I already died. Wow. 2-0 or 2-1. Sorry, Sleep.
Yeah.
His Garbos, obviously, is not garbage, but
right,
you know what I mean.
We all know what you mean.
You know what I mean. Gosh, darn. All right. So level 45 Arcanine is sticking it out with Idol. I'll just go right back into it. And the pick seems to be right, because oh boy, the price is right with this combo. Big damage.
Wow. 50% already.
50% off. Go to Target wholesale. Oh, gets command grab though. That's upsetting. All right, level 45 Arcanine. What can you do?
Ooh! Gotta watch him.
What a mix-up from Hollywood Sleep.
Absolutely.
Crosses him up with that jump medium or jump heavy punch. Excuse me. Throws him back in the corner. Oh, try to go for the restamp. Hits stretch out of the way. Right, DZ. Bro, no, jump back.
Good block. Back dash.
Oh, but he gets hit by the heavy punch.
Got caught. Yep.
All right, he's gonna throw the meter. Here comes the annoying stuff. Oh, yeah, explodes, because that was going to be a command heavy.
Yes.
That was going to break the armor anyway, so it breaks it before he could do anything. Kind of do that. Oh, just came in, dive bomb style. All right, Isik, what are you going to do? Oh, what a combo with
wow.
The minion. Great awareness from Sleep. This perfect play right there.
Oh, teleport.
Oh. All right, good stuff. Arcanine gets in, kills him. Let's see if he's going to stay in. Yes, he is. Oh, but he's going to watch out for it. Oh, he used the jump cancel. I've never seen anyone use a jump cancel there.
But
and
he did.
And he used it to escape skinny. Smart stuff, but this is going to be bad.
Oh. Blocks into good. He doesn't
it ate
care.
The, oh, you know what happened? It ate the birds.
Yeah.
I just heard Jackal yell back. Oh, gets punished from the portal punches. I'll try to go from behind, but gets hit.
Gotta be careful.
Break him lights. Oh, catches him low.
There you go.
And hits both minions to kill both
Jeez.
Of them. He's gonna be behind Jeez. Him with a portal. The portal punches track.
Yep, yep. It is true.
Throw. Oh, yep. Normal throw. Mix up. Same side. Oh, catches him low. Or no, just catches him in the butt.
No shadow counter either. T-bar, full instinct. What do we got? Oh, just stare down. Oh, punish.
That's it. No shadow counter.
Okay.
Leader. Health bars are almost even. This is going to be a big damage combo. It's not going to kill. This is, though.
Oh, my goodness. Level 45 Arcanine playing out of his mind.
Oh, my good
with
golly.
With a character we have drop. Never seen before.
We've never seen Idol before. I think we've seen Idol once.
We've seen him before.
But not at this tournament.
Very not today.
True.
Not at this level, Arcanine with the smirk. He's like, I did it.
Two.
Yeah, you better recognize.
I'm about to eliminate the Evo champ.
I'm going to make a return to top 8, Arcanine says.
I'm about to eliminate.
He's feeling it. Look at it. In his heart and soul, he knows. You teach me and I'll teach you.
Pokemon. You got to learn them all, Pokemon. Yeah.
That's a whole new world you live in.
I don't want to do that. I'm not singing that one.
Let's go.
No, we're done. The bit is over. God
well,
damn
character
it.
Character select again. We're going to Arbiter.
Going to Arbiter. That makes sense. That's what I expected
probably,
from the beginning.
I was surprised at the Gargos pick. I really...
But I think my idea was right. He didn't respect his opponent enough. And because he hadn't, he's now down. Though he's not down, but he's on the verge of elimination.
It's 2-2. Virtual elimination.
Loser's
what a play
bracket.
For Arcanine. Oh, my.
On the verge of not getting back in the top 8.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Boy. Oh, boy. It's
this
lit.
Is Frosty Fossing's 9 game points. Level 45 Arcanine
versus
Hollywood Sleep.
Hollywood Sleep.
Into top 8.
To get in the top 8.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Oh. Okay, get scoops.
Yeah, Sleep is just checking in with these buttons right now.
Oh,
all right. Scoop. Yep, the throw is going to make him avoid the grenade.
Ooh, just recaptured.
Oh, gets hit.
Yeah, gotta watch out for those long normals.
Very true. Oh, tosses the grenade on him. Tried to toss a bullet, I thought I saw, but it didn't really work out for him. All right, another grenade.
Oh, yep, he tried the command grab to survive that
there
grenade.
There it is. There's the command grab. Opt to not go for a gun follow-up. There it is. Recapture. No, the grenade pops just a bit too early. All right, level 45 Arcanine, he's going to activate Instinct.
Ooh.
That's not going to matter,
yeah,
even if he got hit.
He got
the overshield. That's going to kill.
Wow.
Great use of the gun to make sure that was going to kill. Try to catch him. Oh, but it doesn't matter because the overshield, remember.
Okay, missed it.
Oh, rushes in. Try to check him behind.
Teleport, he was expecting it now. Ooh.
Try to break him. I think that was a media. Try to break him. Try to counter break him. Oh, gets a warrior pip, that stuff. Oh, he has full warrior pips now. He's gonna get, meteor hits. He's gonna get another one? No, he's gonna opt to get about 16%, yep. All right, jump over, gonna get hit. Oh, try to parry everything.
There's no timing.
Oh, but he gets, yeah. like I said, Sleep does not know the animations for this character. Level 45 Arcanine could definitely hit him out of some stuff, or catch him with some stuff that he might not know. As you saw right there, the end of the health bar stuff that he might not know. Oh,
no recapture.
Oh, recapture. Grenade pops. Oh,
that
wow.
one will be.
Again. Recapture.
Oh, wow.
Opt to not go. Shoot, last two bullets.
Okay, we got instinct going. Here comes.
Oh,
that's
going to be it. Yep. Lock your time
wow.
now. That's it.
We got a little too overzealous right there.
Hollywood Sleep takes it over. Level 45 Arcanine.
Wow.
And to move into loser's top 8. And.
He's saying he hates Idol. Like, Idol's ridiculous.
He's like, yo, Idol's
ridiculous.
Ridiculous. Gosh darn.
All right. Some great matches in these pools.
Very true.
That was the second half of pools today. First half was played at 10 a.m. this morning, so Central Time.
Central Time.
So
11 a.m. Eastern Time, 9. No, wait. Yeah. 8 Western Time.
Yeah. Oh, right here.
Oh, right there.
Yeah.
Oh, right there.
So it looks like we're going to take a.
A short break.
Brief
Just to get everyone together, get all the top 8 together.
Absolutely.
And, you know, just get
And then we're just gonna do this. So, but here is this combo that we got super pumped from. Level 45 Arcanine.
Yes.
Using the jump cancel over it to avoid like the Rekka punish and then to kill. Just played so
finish
solid.
It with another shadow. That's
just really smart stuff.
Strong stuff from level 45 Arcanine. Really impressive. I mean, he did a great showing last year.
Very
this
true.
Year, just as good of a showing.
Well, not just as good, but like he played better as a player.
Better.
He grew as a player. And like if you compare like his matches from last year to this year, there's so much growth.
Absolutely. This year's competition has been absolutely fierce considering it is the last offline United States
qualifier
for the KRL World Cup. And wow, what a competition it's been. There's been at least 4 to 5 killers in each bracket of
Very
the
true.
Pools. I'm really excited. I didn't get to see who's in top 8 thus far. So who do we have? I know we're waiting a little bit for that, but we obviously know we have Sleep.
Dayton. Amenti. And then I don't know about Base.
Don't know about Base.
I think it's Tubor versus Base.
We don't know about Calypso or Nikki.
Right. Well, no, I think Nikki did.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And then Mello.
Right.
I know Mello did.
Mello made it.
I think Nikki and Mello made it out in winners of the first half of pools.
Wow, I'm really impressed.
Calypso might have made it out in losers. This is not, like, none of this is fact.
These are alternative facts. So.
And then, yeah. So we're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back with the real Killer Instinct Top 8. I'll still be here with a new commentator. Sorry.
It's all right. I'm not Hollywood enough, guys.